Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Blacktown International Sports Park for the gold medal game between WA and Victoria for the Under-16 National Championships. It's a beautiful day out here at Blacktown. A slight breeze from right to left, about 30 degrees. The sun is shining and the teams are all ready to be able to go. We see the plate meeting there between the manager from Victoria Blue, Dan Bertrine, and Rod Drew, the manager for the WA Heat, speaking with the umpires, home plate umpire Terry Ford, first base umpire Ben Nash, and third base umpire Greg Howard. The teams are ready to go, and the lineups for today's game are as follows. For the WA Heat, coming with a 7-1 record, and the home team for today, leading off and playing centre field, is Chase Diggins. The left fielder, Dawson Summers, will hit second. Jesse Williams will play shortstop and hit third. Jake Taylor, coming in with 9 RBIs, leading the team, is in the four hole and playing first base. Mason Talbot is playing third and hitting fifth. Jet Wright, the catcher, will hit sixth. Jackson Riley will play second base today and hit seventh. David John will do the DHing, and he's in the eight hole. And hitting ninth and playing in right field is Alec Johnson, with the starting pitcher Fraser Bryce to take the mound for the WA Heat in this gold medal game. For the Victorian Blue team, they'll be the hitting first today. Leading off for them will be the second baseman Jordan Barnett. Hitting second and playing third base is Cooper Goodman. Justin Burke will do the catching today, and he's hitting in the three hole. Nathan Piccioni will play right field and hit fourth. Jesse Hunter's a DH, and he'll hit in the five hole today. Luke Cartwright playing left field will hit sixth. Big Matt Beattie playing first base will hit seven. Jared Dale playing shortstop will hit eight. Jack Dunn in the nine hole and will play center field. And the starting pitcher is left-hander Mitchell Wilcox. And joining me in the booth is Michael Crosland, who's come in. He'll do the game announcing, and I'm the colour guy, I guess, for today, Crossy.
Willow, great to be up here with you, mate. How you doing?
Fantastic, mate. Excited for the gold medal game. The boys have been out there running around, been watching them take infield, outfield, and as 14 and 15-year-olds do before a gold medal game, they're racing around with plenty of energy.
Plenty of energy, plenty of excitement, and great to have a good group of fans here this afternoon, Willow. As you can see on the camera, it does look like there's empty seats, but it's due to the heat because it's a hot one. The stands right behind home plate are full of the mums and dads and fans out here at Blue Sox Stadium. We've got a big afternoon of baseball. We've got the 16s championship game now and then the 18s to follow. It's going to be a great afternoon.
Yeah, massive afternoon of baseball, and the sun's been shining for a week now. We had a bit of a wet start to the tournament, but the sun has been pounding down. The parents have been in fine form with their yelling and screaming, and they were doing it with the lineup introductions before. Ibo was taking through the lineups across here, and there was plenty of fans getting their practice in for the yelling for this gold medal game.
Got to be something very special for the family to be able to come, especially the guys from Western Australia. I know Victoria's travelled a long way as well, but the heat to travel so far and be here and have such a great crowd for them, obviously a very exciting afternoon.
Yeah, it's probably a culmination of months of hard work. Everyone sees the 10 days or so that they spend in the tournament here, but these parents have been, you know, driving their kids around since they were little. They've taken them to practices, and they've probably, you know, spent hours in the car, plenty of miles, plenty of money to be able to get their kids here, and it's really exciting for them to watch their son playing for a gold medal here in Sydney.
And Willow, it's been a long tournament over 10 days, a few challenges here and there with weather, but obviously it's turned out really, really well.
Yeah, beautiful day for the gold medal game.
Now, I'm going to have a little trouble introducing some of these guys because I'm having trouble reading them, but you fix that up. Leading off is Jordan Barnett, number 32, playing second base. And unfortunately, we don't have too many stats, but I'm sure you might have a little bit up your sleeve because first game to call for the under-16s, and Barnett, 308 for the tournament, obviously playing very, very well.
Yeah, playing very well, looking at trying to get Victoria off to a good start here. Left-handed hitter, and in the leadoff spot, he'll try and get them going here.
Sees that pitch over the plate for a strike. Takes count 2 balls, 1 strike. Fans are making plenty of noise. I hope we have this louder crowd in next week when the Sydney Blue Sox take on the Canberra Cavalry. A must win as the Blue Sox are taking on the Brisbane Bandits at the moment. They've won the last two games, so they need a win this afternoon to make it a 3-1 series.
Yeah, hanging on there. Tied, three-way tie for third place, so right in the hunt, and hopefully the fans are out. The junior Blue Sox fans will be out this afternoon trying to see them win a gold medal as well.
We've just got time down the line. We've had a foul ball come on from Diamond 2.
A couple of games going on there for some of the minor placings there. New South Wales and New South Wales Country are playing in the under 16 game on Diamond 2 there, and in Diamond 3, ACT, I believe, are taking on South Australia.
Hit that ball down the line. That's going to be extra bases. Johnson for Western Australia is going to have to chase that around. And Jordan Barnett gets himself a leadoff double here in the top of the first inning. And he's pretty excited out there at second base.
Oh, absolutely. Pumped up, and what a great start for Victoria Blue. Leadoff double down the right field line there. Really good play by Johnson in right field. Coming over there, making a strong throw into the second baseman, Riley, and onto Williams, but it wasn't in time. Really good swing there by Jordan Barnett, and what a good way to get it started.
And a 308 average for this tournament so far. Obviously, that's going to help with a leadoff double here in the top of the first. Cooper Goodman steps in here, first pitch swinging, and that's going to find some dirt, and that's going to run all the way down to left field, and Summers is going to fire that in and try and hit the cutoff man. And Jordan Barnett comfortably scores from second base, and all of a sudden it's a 1-0 ball game, Willer.
Well, what a start. That's what just what Victoria Blue would be looking for. They came into this game with a 6-2 record. Last time they faced WA, they went down 13-3, and they've come out firing here. Back-to-back hits, double to lead off, and it's 1-0 Victoria Blue. Really good play there by Summers to get it into the cutoff man, Jesse Williams, and keep him to first base, but what a really good start.
First pitch, sees that pitch for a strike. Justin Burke steps in. Already one run in for Victoria. They've jumped out to a flyer here, Willow, and the fans have been on their feet already.
Got them excited early.
Getting an opportunity to make some noise. That ball is hit down the line. That's going to find some dirt as well. That's going to roll all the way down into the Solar Energy bullpen. Goodman's going to advance to second, and Burks gets himself a single here, and we've got runners on second and first with none out as Nathan Piccioni, I believe it is.
Yeah, easy for you to say. Piccioni, maybe.
Piccioni.
Yeah, my wife Layla is Italian, so...
Oh,
I've
there
got
you go. You got it covered.
Somewhat of a background in that, but I've probably butchered that name for sure. Anyway,
you see on the replay there, just scrapes down the line. Doesn't get too much on it, but these aluminium bats, Willow, they make it a little handy for a young guy to hit the ball in the gap.
Yeah, the Baseball Australia made the change earlier in the tournament. They went to the BB Core bats there, so a little less lively than the -5 bats they were swinging previously, but when you've got some of the best 14 and 15 year old hitters in the country, they know how to do it, and Victoria Blue has done that. They've gone line to line and used the whole field so far for an early one run lead, and first and second with nobody out here, and the cleanup hitter up.
They've certainly jumped out, getting after Bryce, who's on the bump for Western Australia, and he doesn't realise what's hit him. All of a sudden he's come out, he's thrown about 13 pitches, and it's 1-0 with another runner in scoring position.
And in the four hole, for good reason, he's leading his team in RBI. So hopefully he'll be trying to add to that total and do some damage right here.
That ball is hit hard out to left field. Summers tracking back, but that's going to find some grass. It rolls all the way out to the fence. Goodman's going to score. Burke rounding third, heading for home. There's going to be a play at home plate and cut off, and he scores. And Piccioni gets himself a couple more RBIs with a double here with none out. Takes the score 3-0. Willow, you just said he's had plenty of RBIs for the season or the tournament so far, and he ticks up another couple.
Yeah, really good swing there. He got ahead in the count there, got a fastball up out over the plate and drove that ball over Summers' head in left field. They did a really good job and a really good relay play there. Close play at the plate, but when you swing the bat like that and you drive it all the way in the gap on these big fields here, it's tough not to drive in a couple of runs there.
Piccioni kept his weight back. You can see on the replay, Bryce just left that one hanging a little as Jess Hunter steps in, and he did not miss it. That ball rolled all the way out onto the warning track and bumped into the fence. Amazing power for these young kids. It's funny to be up here calling, and these guys are 14 and 15 years old, Willow. It's insane. Used to calling the ABL guys, but wonderful to see these guys out here, and I find it very amusing to see that these guys are so young, but they have such great talent.
Yeah, amazing talent. These are our next ABL players, next national team players, and these kids are out at ABL games watching their heroes play, and they're trying to emulate what they do.
Williams wants pickoff. Piccioni hustles hard back in the second. We apologise to the fans at home if we're getting any of these names incorrect. I just literally got off the plane, was driven out here, ran straight up and was introduced. I'm still trying to get my lineup sheet right. As Hunter sees that pitch for a strike, takes count one ball and two strikes. But great for grandmas and grandpas and brothers and sisters and mums and dads that couldn't make the journey here to Sydney. A great opportunity for them to watch this game as Williams at shortstop hustles in. That ball gets thrown out to Diggins in center field. Just trying to check him back, keep him nice and tight.
Yeah, it must be a big thrill to be able to tune on and watch your son, your grandson.
Yeah.
Your mate watching baseball from all the way across the other side of the country if you're in Perth and get a chance to tune in and see your family and friends playing for a gold medal.
And I'm pretty sure that these games are all kept on as this ball is hit high into the air. Williams is racing back, might find some grass, but a great grab by Williams. Has pretty good range out there, Willow, and does a good job camping under that pitch.
Yeah, very good actions there at shortstop. Made a really good play. The sun's high in the sky. There's not too many clouds around, so that one's always going to be tough. Jesse Williams goes back, looks over his left shoulder, takes it under control, gets under the ball. Good communication there with his outfielders and takes a catch for the first out of the inning.
And I guess the manager from Western Australia will be saying, thank God we finally got an out. But as you know, at this sort of level, Willow, there's a three-run, a four-run, a five-run lead is nothing, really. They can bounce back very, very quickly as Cartwright steps in, sees first pitch for a strike.
Yeah, absolutely. We saw that in the bronze medal game, earlier. New South Wales Country gave up three in the first, and they just come back, stuck with it, ended up taking up a bronze medal in the under-18s, 4-3. Alexander Wells pitched a hell of a game for them. Young Jai Deeble for Queensland matched it with him for most of the game. And, it's national championships, and everyone's, you know, pretty nervous for that first inning. And Rod Drew's a pretty seasoned campaigner. I've seen him a lot of junior tournaments and does a lot of work with WA Heat over there with their junior programs. And I'm sure that he's a seasoned veteran. He'll get the kids back on track and, you know, there's a lot of baseball to play.
I was informed as I arrived into the foreground and got swamped by the New South Wales Country boys that there's a pretty good grab in the ninth inning out in right field. It looked like it was going to find some grass and bounce off the wall possibly, but the right fielder Hustleback made the grab, and that was the ball game.
Yeah, it was an outstanding catch. Tough to play right field here in the spacious confines of Blacktown International Sports Park. And Murray Lugg went back and made an outstanding catch right on the warning track.
The ball is hit high in the air to Diggins, hustling back in centre field. Piccioni's tagging up, and he's going to try for third and comfortably gets into third as Diggins does a good job making the grab, fires it into Williams and over to Talbot, but not in time.
Yeah, really good swing there and good contact. Diggins really tracked that ball well, came out throwing, and really good base running there by Piccioni to get over to third base.
It's amazing how different it is, Willow, and I'm sure you would know the feeling when you're on the bump and there's a runner on second, you're a little bit concerned. But when a guy's 90 feet away, all of a sudden, the last thing you want to do is miss that breaking pitch or that off-speed pitch, and ball gets passed right here, all of a sudden it's a 4-0 ball game.
Yeah, it takes a lot of different different elements there to be able to get guys out. Now there's, you know, pass balls, and it, you know, probably puts in the back of your mind here, I need to make perfect pitches. The catcher is maybe a little bit tentative, knowing that he needs to keep that ball in front. So a little bit of pressure here in the first inning, down by three already, and the runner on third base and two out.
Beattie steps in, sees first pitch for a ball. Williams doing a good job at shortstop. He makes plenty of movement out there. Loves to run around and back up and get his job done.
Yeah, he's loving the game. He's right into it right away. So he's got a chance to see him play early this week. And that's one of the good things everyone says about him, that this kid loves to play the game. I spoke to Steve Fish, who's the high performance manager over there in Perth, and also the Perth Heat manager. He has a lot to do with these teams and does an excellent job. And, you know, credit to him for having the under-16 team here in the gold medal game and the under-18 team later today. But, you know, so that's what he says about Jess Williams. He said ever since he's been a little kid, he's been in his programs and out there and just loving to play the game, and you can really see it.
That's really the future of this sport, isn't it? These kids, and wonderful to see them. Both teams in the 16s and the 18s gold medal game, they would be very, very happy. As Beattie, you would see on the replay there, he does have a leg guard or ankle guard on, and he did take one straight off the ankle before, so probably does that a little bit, likes to pull the ball. Beattie, two balls, one strike, sees that pitch for strike two.
Yeah, good breaking ball there by Bryce. Come back and even the count.
Takes count. Two across the board, two balls, two strikes, two out. See on the replay, just snaps, and that's a nice pitch. Got to keep reminding myself, these are 15-year-old kids. This ball is hit on the ground, going to chop foul.
Yeah, especially when you see the likes of Matt Beattie up there. He's, you know, probably 6 foot two, 6 foot three. There's some really big, really athletic kids getting out there. Lucky you're not down there, Crosby. So.
I am definitely not standing anywhere near Beattie after this game because I'd probably come up to his letters. I wouldn't get much higher on that jersey. I think I'm 5'7", maybe 168 centimetres tall, so there's not much of me. That ball's a little slow chopping down the line and they're going to let this one roll foul. And I guess that's a bit of an advantage after playing here for 10 games, right? Very often you would see a third baseman, maybe game one, Talbot might charge in, try and pick that up and make the barehanded play. But he knows how the field works and how the ball's going to roll and he just sees that one foul and obviously that just protected him a run.
Absolutely. Really mature play there by Talbot to come in there and, you know, like we keep talking about, we're in the gold medal game here. Obviously, the players are nervous. They want to do really, really well. And, you know, it would have been, you know, like quite easily for him to come in and try and make that play and throw out Beattie. Beattie runs really well. And you can see there, he's always almost at first base by the time he would have picked that up. So really good mature play.
2-2. Sees that pitch high and inside. Takes count full.
Back to the breaking ball there and just missed with it. It was a good pitch and a good call there by Terry Ford, the home plate umpire. That ball was just in.
Takes the count full. Bryce battling on the bump here. Giving up three runs so far in the first inning. Hits his spot on the outside corner. Strike three. And Beattie has struck out. But the damage has been done. Victoria jumped out to a big early lead. Put up a crooked number in the top of the first. 3-0. We'll be right back. Bottom of the first. Due up. Chase, Dawson and Jess.
And so too is the Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in 2000 at MLB Network?
Welcome back to Blue Sox Stadium here at Blacktown International Sports Park. If you've just joined us, under-16s gold medal game, Victoria and Western Australia. Victoria have jumped out to a 3-0 lead. The boys just got out after it early. Barnett, Goodman, Burke, Piccioni, they all managed to get doubles and singles to get some runs in. And now it's time for the Western Australia boys to battle here with Chase Diggins stepping up to lead off. Lefty on the mound, Wilcox starts hitting his spot, and Diggins has had a pretty good tournament so far.
Yeah, comes in like a lot of the WA Heat boys here with some with high averages. They've swung the bats great to put themselves obviously in this tournament, and they come with a pretty tough offense. It's going to be tough for Wilcox today, and hopefully he keeps them in check and pounds the strike zone, gets after it, and we see Diggins there, you know, good and aggressive, and you know, tall, slender built young man who can run a little bit and in the leadoff spot for good reason.
I bet you can run a little. 467 for the tournament. That is an impressive number.
Very good number. Very good number.
How many at-bats is that? 15 at-bats. So that's pretty solid as well. He gets after that one. Hits that high into the air. Piccioni out in right field. Camps under that one. And Diggins is retired for the first out here in the bottom of the first inning. Dawson Summers due up, and he's these guys have all got very good averages, and obviously that's why they're here in the finals, as you see on the replay. Just gets under that one a little, and Diggins loops that one out into right field and pitching only camps under it comfortably.
Yeah, we see left-handed Summers turning up here, and it's really important for young Wilcox to get in there and to attack the hitters, pound the zone. His team's giving him an early three-run lead, and hopefully he can keep that in check and get them back in the dugout and looking to score some more runs. And WA, they'd be looking to try and put those good batting averages to good use, put him under pressure a little bit and try and peg back some of that lead.
Unbelievable. Looking at these stats, the entire nine, that ball is hit hard down the line and just hooking foul. That would no doubt be extra bases for Summers, as he certainly has some wheels in the two spot.
Yeah, definitely. That was a really good swing there. He gets a fastball in right here and turns on it and just foul there. So that's what they would have been looking for. But now he's got a chance to be able to get back at him and get on base.
I was just saying before we just called that big foul down the right field line, pretty much the entire nine are hitting above 350. That's some pretty impressive averages. The ball's hit on the ground. First baseman Booty gets under that one. And he is retired for the second out. You said Beattie's a big guy. He is a giant at first base.
Yeah, very, very big kid, very tall, and he dwarfs a lot of the other guys when they're in and around him. So, big kid, big athlete with a really good arm and playing some first base today.
Hitting in a three-hole. Jess Williams sees that pitch off the plate for ball one.
We talked about his defense. He's coming in hitting 429. He's leading the team in stolen bases. So he's a bit of a catalyst for this team, I think. And hitting in the three hole for good reason. And like I was saying, speaking with Steve Fish, he has nothing but good things to say about young Jesse Williams, as he does about a lot of the players that are on this club.
I guess that's why they're in the team, right, Willow? They've got the right attitude and clearly the right skills, but they've got to battle back here. Seven inning game or nine inning game with these guys?
Seven innings. The under 16s. Yep. Yeah, 9 innings in under 18s there. So
a big afternoon of baseball. Sees that pitch for a strike. Takes count 3-1. Wilcox does his work early, doesn't he? He comes to a set and he delivers. There's no messing around. He just likes to work quickly.
Yeah.
Lefty lefty matchup. That ball is hit hard out to right field. Piccioni camps under that one. And Wilcox does his job. 1-2-3 here in the bottom of the first inning. Kick to a commercial break. We'll be right back for the top of the second. Victoria lead Western Australia 3-0. You up top of the second, Jared Dale, Jack Dunn, and then back to the leadoff man, Jordan Barnett. And the Victorian boys jumped out early to a 3-0 lead. Willow got some talent with the stick.
Yeah, definitely. They scored those three runs. Wilcox came out and just dealt in that first inning. So some hard hit balls, but some good defense, and they come into the top of the second here with a 3-run lead.
Big swing and a miss by Dale. Strike one.
And a pretty famous name in Victorian and Australian baseball, Dale. This is Jared's the son of national team pitching coach and Australian Baseball Hall of Famer Phil Dale.
little talent in the family.
Yeah, and playing shortstop like his older brother does with the Kansas City Royals, or who's an infielder, Ryan Dale, who's playing for the Aces and signed with the Kansas City Royals last year. So really good bloodlines for young Jared.
And his brother was okay after a little scuffle the other night. That was pretty intense, and managed to make national news and, in fact, world news in America.
Yeah, right into it. The boys are getting stuck into it down there in Adelaide, and obviously a little bit of animosity between the teams, and weren't too happy about it, I don't think.
Dale drills this one down the line, going to roll all the way down to the Solar Energy bullpen for a foul. Nice swing by the young guy. Having a little trouble this tournament, hitting 1-1-1, but it's not about your last at-bat, right, Willow? It's about your next one, and he's got no real pressure here. He's jumped out to a 3-0 lead. He'll be relaxed, and time to have a good at-bat here as he puts another foul and takes count 2 balls, 2 strikes.
It's always difficult in these tournaments, too, with limited at-bats. You get a couple of balls hard, like we saw in the first inning for the WA Heat, come up empty, and before you know it, you're under the pump. So a couple of hits here and there, and your batting average will go through the roof. So averages are tough to be able to judge hitters by, and you know, good to see him out there in the gold medal game playing shortstop. So a premium position for Victoria Blue, and obviously he's done a good enough job to be out there. And we see there he chases a pitch and battles off a tough breaking ball there thrown by Bryce.
And that is a lot tougher than what it looks. That was a really good battle. Very easy to swing over the top of that as it breaks 12-6. He did a good job as he sees this one hit him in the back of the leg, and he'll get himself aboard here with none out in the top of the second.
He went to the breaking ball again and lost a little bit inside, and Jared Dale takes that one on the leg, and we've got a leadoff runner on again.
I can't stress that enough, right, Willow? You would agree that breaking balls, especially when you've got a couple of strikes on you, off the plate outside, last thing you want to do is roll over. He sort of looked off balance, but he did just enough to get wood on it. You're never trying to hit that ball for a base hit. You're just trying to foul it off as Dunn steps in, sees first pitch off the plate.
Yeah, definitely young Jared there was trying to keep that at-bat alive and did enough to be able to foul that ball off. Battles through, gets a pitch, gets hit, and does a job for the team here and lead-off runner on base right now.
I haven't had a chance to watch too much of this tournament as I live quite a ways away up in sunny Sawtell. But one thing that reminded me a little of Jared Dale's at-bat is a little bit like Trent D'Antonio for the Blue Sox. He does a lot of that. He battles, and if he doesn't get the pitch he wants, he just puts the wood out there to try and foul it off and come give me a good pitch that I can hit.
Yeah, definitely. A lot of hitting's got to do with just getting up there and making sure you compete. It's the battle between you and the pitcher. The pitcher's trying to do everything he can to try and make you swing at pitch. Swinging a bad pitch, swinging a pitch that you don't want to swing at and that he wants you to put in play. And a lot of the time you've got to just do whatever you can with whatever pitch you see.
That ball is hit hard down the left field line. That's going to find some grass. That's going to run past Summers. Summers is going to have to make a big play to try and get this in. Dale round second, heads for third comfortably, and Dunn gets himself a double here in the top of the second inning.
That ball was hit really well. We see there on the Victorian Blue using the entire field. We see some really hard hit balls, some doubles there, and really good swing by Jack Dunn there. And tough to take off there for Jared Dale. Tough ball to be able to see, but he gets all the way around to third base. WA Heat again, and I know that they're giving up some hits here, but a really good relay play there. Good throw in by Summers into Jesse Williams. Everyone's in good position, and that's testament to the coaches and the guys running the programs over there in WA.
Jordan Barnett steps in here with two runners on in scoring position as he sees first pitch for a strike. And that's Dunn's second hit for the tournament. But, wow, he did not miss that thing. That was crushed down the line.
Yeah, big athlete and a really good swing there, showing some bat speed and driving that ball into left field corner.
Heat coaching staff have asked all the boys to play in, as you'll see from the high camera right there. They're all well and truly on the grass. They cannot afford to give up any more runs. There's a little bit of movement down in the Solar Energy bullpen. Ellis Deacon's hustling down there to warm up one of the boys to throw as Barnett sees that pitch high.
Another good at-bat here by Barnett. We see him in the leadoff spot. He took that swing, got the Victorian Blue team off to a really good start with a double in the first, and looking to capitalise and execute and get another run in here.
2 balls, 1 strike. That ball misses low and inside. Bryce having a little battle up on the mound, Willow. I don't know what you can see, but from the angle that I'm at, it almost looks like that front leg is really blown open. He's not really stepping towards the plate, and it looks like he's having a little trouble finding the zone as it's a 3-1 count. Big swing and a miss for strike two.
Good pitch there. He came back with a 3-1 change-up by the looks of it, and the good thing for me so far is Jet Wright's done a really good job, and it looks like that young Bryce there has a lot of confidence in him. He's thrown some breaking balls in the dirt, and Jet Wright's been back there blocking everything, keeping everything in front.
Barnett hits this one straight to the first baseman in Taylor. Looks like he's going to be doubled off at second. And he is. That's a great play. Dunn is backdoored at second. A great job by Williams to hustle over and make that play. Line drive to Taylor. Makes the grab. Fires it over to Williams. Hopefully we can get a nice replay of that, because that ball was hit on the nose by Barnett.
Yeah, really good swing right here. He puts a great swing on it. Line drive straight to the first baseman over there in Taylor. And a young base running mistake there by young Jack Dunn. Gets a little bit too far off. Fires it over to Jesse Williams, and Jesse Williams puts a tag on him.
Hard hit ground ball to Williams. Plenty of time. Fires it over to first. And Goodman is retired for the third out. A big momentum shift here in the top of the second inning. We've been speaking momentum all season long in the ABL, Willow. But that was a big shift there. We're going to be back for the bottom of the second inning. Victoria lead Western Australia 3-0.
Ground ball back at the pitcher. Tola recovers, and Canberra are the champions of Australian baseball.
The month of February is fast approaching, and so too is the Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in 2015 at MLB Network?
Due up here for Western Australia in the bottom of the second inning. Taylor, Talbot, and Wright. Taylor hitting in the four hole, playing first base. Turned a nice double play in the top of the second inning to get the Western Australia boys really out of a jam with none out, runners on second and third. Willow, coaching staff from Victoria would be pretty eager to see him score a run, but momentum shift a little back to the Heat's favour with a double play and then a nice play by Williams at shortstop.
Yeah, really good play by Taylor there. That ball was really hardly hit there by young Barnett. Straight to him, makes a nice play, turns around, and you know, Jack Dunn got a little bit too far off there. Fired a nice throw over to Jesse Williams, put the tag on him for a double play. So really good job there by Fraser Bryce. Again, in a little bit of early trouble, but came back and keeps pounding the strike zone, keeps going away, and his defense has really picked him up there. And you know, big fella here will be looking to try and get on base. He's had 9 RBIs and
hits his ball high in the air, but Dunn's going to camp under that one, and he is comfortably retired. But back to that double play, very often you see, Willow, that the first baseman might get a little bit excited. You know, he'll come up, he'll catch the ball, he'll fire it to second base at Williams, and Williams might not be there, for example. All of a sudden the ball goes into left field and they score a run, but a really good job. And as you can see on the replay, Taylor did a good job digging that thing out of the dirt. And still got a little power to make it all out to center field as Talbot steps in here with one out. First pitch looking, see strike one.
Talbot's had a really good series as well. He's hitting 357. I saw him having at bat the other day where he almost hit one out on Diamond 2. So wow. He's got some power. Looks like he's swinging a bomb bat there. So obviously he's got enough strength to be able to swing a bat there. And like we talked about, going to the BB core bats, it's you know, they're very similar to the wooden bats. It's the same bats they use in college. So some of the young players here who've got the strength to be able to swing wooden bats or bomb bats have opted to be able to go with that.
Talbot puts this one high into the air. Dunn's going to have to hustle in. Plenty of time. Camps under that one for the second out. And what are your thoughts on that, Will? Obviously, you know, in this league, they're allowed to use 10. They have the opportunity for that little advantage that some may say. But then I'm guessing by the size of Talbot, he's probably second year 16s, I'm guessing. And he's probably moves up to the 18s next year and needs to use wood. What are your thoughts on some of these players? In fact, I've only seen Talbot himself as the only guys, right, swings and misses that pitch using a wood bat.
Yeah, there's a couple of guys from Victoria Blue. I think Justin Burke swings a bomb bat as well. I think it comes down to comfort level, what they've used to been using and getting out there and doing it. So it probably comes down to a strength thing. The metal bats, although the ball's not jumping off as far, hard, probably have a bit bigger of a sweet spot, a little bit more room for error, but the kids that are comfortable swinging the bomb bats have been doing that and doing reasonably well.
Beatty makes a nice play at first base and retires the side quickly again. 1-2-3, we're through two complete. Victoria lead Western Australia 3-0. Top of the third, you up for Vicks. Burke, Piccioni and Hunter. They got shut down very well by Bryce in the top of the second, but now we battle again here in the top of the third.
Yeah, Bryce out there again. He's got to go through the heart of the order here, and Justin Burke will lead off out of the left-handed batter's box here and look to try and get on base and capitalise on the base hit that he had earlier in the game.
Fastball inside low for ball one. Pitching numbers, I know that at this level they certainly have maximum amount of pitches, minors and majors and all that sort of stuff. What would these guys have?
Yeah, a lot of it comes down to the participation and where what players have done previously and how many days rest they've had. So it's all there to be able to protect the players. I would be assuming that Rod Drew and his staff would have had young Fraser Bryce there lined up and he'll be able to go to the maximum pitch count today. So around 70, 80 pitches or so. And as long as he's staying out of trouble and keeping his team in the game, then I'm sure that I'll go with him.
It's amazing at these sort of tournaments, Willow, where you need to play for tomorrow's game, but you need to win today. You know, it's a real challenge for management.
Yeah, definitely. I spoke with Stuart Bell yesterday a little bit about it before New South Wales Country took on New South Wales in the semi. And he had Lachlan Wells and Alex Wells lined up and, you know, he had all of his game plans there and his whole MO for that was, you know, we've got to get to that gold medal game. We can't
rely on. Lachlan gets him there Brother gets him.
Yeah, exactly right. If we need to go to Alex and you know, keep that lead. So it was a really hard-fought game. Lachlan Wells pitched great. Brad Simon for New South Wales pitched a gem of a game and New South Wales came out the victors 6-0 in that game and they'll play for the gold medal today.
Wow.
Country with a really good result with the bronze medal. And it could have gone either way yesterday. And you know, it's a credit to Stuart Bell and the hard work that he's put in with country baseball.
Burke picks himself a 5-pitch walk as a leadoff man aboard here with none out.
Yeah, third time that's happened this game. So Fraser Bryce having a little bit of trouble at the start of each inning. He pitched out of a jam last inning and, you know, look to try and get a ground ball here and hopefully get a double play and keep his team in the game.
And Piccioni steps in. Got himself a double last at bat with a couple of RBIs, taking his RBI total through the roof. And his first pitch swinging. He must be seeing the ball like a beach ball out there with a batting average of 529 coming into today's game. He is clearly seeing it well.
Yeah, definitely. Probably a lot of confidence coming in, really enjoying himself. RBI, a couple of RBI double in his first at bat, so he'll be up there seeing it like a beach ball and trying to repeat that and do some damage here for the Vic Blue.
Burkett first. Piccioni here, second pitch, swinging hard. That ball is in the outfield. Summers down at left field line. Camps under that one. And Piccioni is retired for the first out here in the top of the third inning.
Nice swing. Just got underneath that, yeah. And a nice play by Summers there. The sun's always difficult, and we've seen that with a lot of the Blue Sox games this year, a lot of the day games for the players there. So young players coming in, you know, a lot of really good actions there. He moved under that ball really easily, and we see he's got the sunglasses on there, shields the sun, catches the ball, and gets it back into these infielders.
As Jesse Hunter steps in, and you mentioned the Blue Sox game, it was only a two series ago. That ball is hit hard on the ground. Riley flicks it to Williams. Williams fires it over to Taylor, and that's a 4-6-3 double play to end here in the top of the third inning. We're just saying back to the Blue Sox, there was a couple of issues in one game in particular where our left fielder managed to drop two balls in the one inning due to the sun. As you can see there, nice double play on the replay, 4-6-3. We're going to be right back for the bottom of the third inning. Victoria lead Western Australia 3-0.
Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in 2 Network?
Barber makes the play, and it's all over. And the perfect hit at bat.
Right. You up here in the bottom of the third inning, Riley Jackson, John David, and Johnson. Allel, is it? I believe. Allel? A-L-E-L. Is that the correct spelling?
Well, I'll have to look at that. We're going off the lineup card. And
we'll get back to it. But
Alec Johnson.
Alec Johnson. They're all the other way, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
Jackson Riley, David John, and Alex Johnson. That's nice and confusing to have the surnames and the first names switched around on both scorecards just to keep us on our toes today. Sorry to the fans at home, mums and dads and nans and pops. Sees that pitch for a strike. Takes count, 2-1. I guess they could be two first names, right? Jackson and Riley.
Potentially, yeah.
As this ball is hit on the nose, and that's going to find some grass. Piccioni's going to race around and fire that into the shortstop of Dale. He gets himself a single here in the bottom of the third inning, and that's exactly what the Heat needed.
Yeah, good start there. We see young Jackson Riley taking a nice swing here. Ball out over the plate and drives that ball into right centre. So I saw Jackson's dad, Darren Riley. I was a bat boy for him at Petersham Baseball Club all those years ago. So not to make Darren feel old, but I saw him racing around there, and now I'm seeing his young fella who's probably older than I was when I was his bat boy.
That's awesome. As David John steps in.
Another left-handed hitter here for the WA Heat. So they've stacked the lineup there. A lot of good left-handed hitters coming in with all those averages, and Vic Blues countered that with a good lefty on the mound here with a good breaking ball.
Nice little lefty-lefty matchup. And you're right, Jackson Riley did a great job keeping his way back and driving that ball opposite field. Don't know whether you could hear at home that unique sound that BB Core bat makes. You certainly know when you've hit it.
Yeah, absolutely. Really good sound off the bat. Good solid contact.
David John sees that one over the plate for a strike. Takes count, 2-1. David John hit in the 8 hole, DH this afternoon. 357 batting average. Loves to swing the stick. Burke sets up outside. Wilcox does the job hitting it outside, but John fouls that one off.
Yeah, young Wilcox's control has been really good so far. He's attacked the zone, thrown a lot of strikes there, and we see that pitch there made to David John. It's a big left-handed hitter. We've got an open lane over there at the 4 hole there. He'd be looking to try and pull the ball through there and you know, try and get Jackson Riley over there to third base and start off the inning.
Jackson Riley comfortably advances to second with a little bobble behind the dish, and now David John's got an opportunity to get himself an RBI here with full count, none out.
Yeah, he'd be looking to drive him in. A really good read there on a dirt ball. Breaking ball in the dirt. Justin Burke goes to his knees, blocks that ball, and Jackson Riley takes off right away, gets to second base here with nobody out.
Burke did a pretty good job keeping the ball where it was as John flies this one down the line, and Goodman tracking back, and that's going to just get past him and find the grass for a foul. And the count remains the same at 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Yeah, good effort by Goodman going back on that ball, and we see here David John popping this ball up, and maybe the sun comes in to consideration here. We just saw Goodman looking back up there at the sun, and we see him trying to shield his eyes there, but really tough play. It was always going to be a tough play and a really good effort to try and get to that ball.
Right in front of the complete surrounds beer garden. Have you had a chance yet this season, Willow, to spend some time down there?
Potentially, I may have. I've sat down there. I haven't enjoyed the cool beverages they have down there. But I saw Darian Lindsay, the Blue Sox pitching coach, sweating away building that beer garden. It's a really, really good place to watch the game.
Yeah, it's certainly a fan favourite. The crowd certainly love it down there. No fence in front. As management come out for Victoria to have a few words, but yeah, you see the fans really get after it down there, and they get a lot of foul balls as well.
Yeah,
and you got to be on your toes with no net.
Yeah, it's entertaining. It's probably entertaining for young Zach Shepherd that plays down there. So a lot of the fans are probably giving him a little bit of lip, but a little bit lighthearted. I wouldn't want to be playing third base for the opposition down there in about the seventh inning when people have had 1,000. So yeah, but it adds a great atmosphere to the game, and what an awesome place to be able to sit there and watch the game, have a beer, and enjoy the ABL.
Yeah, it's a really good spot as Alex Johnson shapes around very, very early. In this situation, none out. Wants to put the ball on the ground and give Chase Diggins, who's hitting 467, to get himself a couple of RBIs. Johnson shapes around again. First pitch puts this bunt right to the first baseman of Beattie. Beattie fires it over to Barnett, who's covering it first.
Nice play there by Matt Beattie. That was excellent. Really good execution all the way around. We see Alex Johnson square around and bunting that ball. Matt Beattie comes in. Victorian Blue team, everyone's where they need to be. And you can tell that through the hours of practice that Dan Petrine and Damien Shanahan and his staff have put in with this club, that the kids know exactly where they need to go, and executed perfectly. Really, really good baseball.
Good call, Willow. Everybody did their job, right? The hitter did the job, putting the ball on the ground, and everybody moved the right way. And big opportunity here in the bottom of the third inning for Western Australia. Jackson Riley at third, David John at second, and Diggins getting the job done behind the plate. Gets a real good hitter's count here as Wilcox falls behind 2-0.
Yeah, hitting at 467 coming into this game, a 2-0 count with runners in scoring position. So be looking to drive a pitch here and try and get a run in, at least one run in for the WA Heat.
Good hitters count 2-0 as he gets after that one and fouls it down the line. Yeah, big opportunity. All of a sudden, the game can change on one swing of the bat with Diggins in the box here. Puts this ball on the ground to Goodman. Goodman fires it over to first. Beattie does a good job. But the Heat score a run here as young Riley Jackson comfortably scores from third, and David John did a good job advancing to third on that play.
Yeah, really good base running there. We saw the third baseman Goodman going over to his left, catches the ball. As soon as he lets go of that ball, David John took off running to third base. He got a really good secondary lead here. We see it on the camera. As soon as he throws the ball, he takes off to third base, vacant over there at third, gets over to third base, and we've got two out here with a runner at third.
Dawson, first pitch swinging. And it just shows execution how important that bunt was, right? He doesn't bunt there and there's a runner on first and second. Hit a hard ground ball to shortstop and Dale flicks it to Barnett for a quick double play, and all of a sudden there's two out with a runner on third as Dawson hits this ball high in the air. And that's going to land in front of Piccioni, and David John's going to comfortably score from third base, and Dawson Summers gets himself an RBI single here with two out, takes the score 3-2. We've got ourselves a ball game, Willer.
Yeah, perfect. And we keep harping back on that bunt by Alec Johnson. Puts the bunt down, moves the runners into scoring position. Ground ball to get the run in. Base hit gets the run in. We could have gone it with no runs in this inning, but the WA Heat have put themselves right back into this game. One run game on some really well executed baseball.
A little two out rally here. First pitch swinging. Jess hits this ball high in the air. Cartwright comfortably camps under that one. And Western Australia are retired here in the bottom of the third inning. But a little damage done. They put up a crooked number. Takes the score 3-2. Victoria lead Western Australia. Welcome back to Blue Sox Stadium here, Blacktown International Sports Park. We're through three complete. Victoria lead Western Australia 3-2 in this under-16s gold championship battle as Cartwright, Beattie and Dale are due up for Victoria. And Bryce still on the bump. Nice breaking ball, strike one.
We've settled into this game really, really well. We talked about the three runs in the first. A little bit of trouble there. Team picks him up with a double play and he came out, dealt last inning, and he's got right ahead here at Cartwright 0-2.
Momentum, momentum, momentum. It's amazing what it can do, especially in the confidence of a young athlete like Bryce. You know, yeah, he gives up three runs, but then to come out and put up a couple of zeros in a row, really that momentum shift and that confidence is going to be really sit well for him.
Yeah, it might have been a long night for him there too. If he found out that he was starting the gold medal game, probably coming in here with a lot of nerves. And, yeah, we see there a breaking ball that hit Cartwright on the elbow. The umpires have awarded him first base, and Rod Drew's coming out to question whether or not he's lent out over the plate. It looks kind of close. There, but would have been really difficult for the umpire to be able to call him back here. So we'll see the umpires, Terry Ford, Ben Nash and Greg Howard will come together and discuss this.
Yeah, manager Drew was not really happy with that call. And as you can probably see on the replay, you know, that's a 50-50 call, right? He definitely leaned over and in fact, it almost looked like it was going to sneak in there for a strike and he leant right over just late. That... We'll let you at home make that call, but umpires have had a little discussion and the call still stands and Cartwright gets himself aboard here with none out in the top of the fourth inning as Matthew Beattie steps in. What are your thoughts on that?
Would have been tough for the umpires to be able to change that one. It's always hard if a hitter gets hit by a pitch and, you know, to determine whether he did it on purpose or not and all of those things. So it would have been tough there. No dramas with Rodri questioning that and, you know, probably no dramas with the umpires not changing it.
Yeah, good call. Good call. As Beattie sees that first pitch, ball one. Yeah, judgment calls like that, very difficult to make a change unless, you know, one of the guys up the middle who were umpiring saw it better. But they're both on the corners on that, so it's pretty tough to see it.
Yeah, really tough.
As he takes off, and that's going to be a hit and run. He fouls that one down the line. Cartwright, really good jump there, Willa.
Yeah, great jump there. We see the hit and run put on there by Dan Bertrine as the Vic Blue manager, and really good jump, well executed by Matt Beattie. You look to try and hit the ball as hard as you can, low and hard there wherever it's pitched, and you got a fastball down and in and pulled it foul. So well executed, but just didn't keep it fair.
One ball, one strike. This ball is hit hard on the ground to Talbot. Talbot fires it over to Riley, who throws it over to Taylor, and that's a 5-4-3 double play, and that's a big play.
Yeah, great play there. The defense has been outstanding so far in this game. Young Fraser Bryce there gets a sinker down in on Matt Beattie. See the third baseman, Talbot, across to Riley, across to Taylor, and Taylor made double play, really close here at first base, and bang, bang. We'll call that one a bang, bang, bang play, but really well executed, really good defense.
That ball is hit hard on the ground as well, and that's going to sneak all the way out into left field of Summers. Talbot took a little nasty hop, but one thing I want to touch on that double play, regardless of how bang, bang or bang, bang it was, Willow, is that Talbot, really, really good feed to Riley, and it's so important in a double play like that to get the first guy.
Yeah, you always talk to young infielders about getting the first out. Their job is to be able to catch the ball, deliver it to the second baseman, something they can handle, and we see Riley, he got the perfect tailor-made throw there to be able to catch, turn, and make a really strong throw over there to Taylor.
Dale takes off from first, and he's going to comfortably make it into second on a little wayward throw by Wright. I think the ball would have beat him, but just not on the spot. And all of a sudden, Jack Dunn, opportunity here to get himself an RBI. Top of the fourth, and Dale looks like he maybe corked himself as he slid into second. You'll see on the replay, breaking pitch. So it's a tough play, and Wright definitely would have beat him with the throw. Just takes a little nasty hop, and Williams doesn't get a glove on it. He slides very, very late. Looks like he lands straight onto the base. Neither here nor there. He's safe at second, and that ball bounces maybe 55 feet. Didn't make the distance there, Willa.
Yeah, aggressive on the base paths there of the Victorian Blue team. So looking to try and shift the momentum back their way. Jack Dunn with a big double down the left field line there, and Jared Bias hustling there on the first pitch of the at-bat. He's in scoring position, and be looking to try and send him here on a base hit to right field.
That ball's going to find some grass, and he's rounding third and heading home, and there's a little bobble out in right field by Johnson, and he comfortably scores, and that's great aggressive coaching. Gets a really good read on that, keeps his way back, drills it into right field out in Johnson. All he needed to do was a little bobble, and he comfortably scores.
Yeah, really, really good. You want to be aggressive there with two outs, obviously. And Jared Dow gets a good secondary lead. Jack Dunn puts a good swing on it, takes off right away, and you're probably erring on the side of sending him there. And Dan Bertrine kept him going and in there easily for the fourth run of the game for the Vic Blue.
And plenty of movement down in the Solar Energy bullpen, and management Rod Drew is going to go out and have a little chat, and it looks like we may possibly have a pitching change. And Willow, your thoughts on this, mate? Probably time, 4-2, given up 7 hits so far. He's battled really, really well, though.
Yeah, he's kept him in the game, Fraser Bryce. It's very easy for a young man to get caught up in a gold medal game, give up 2 or 3 runs early in the game and kind of lose his bundle. But he's been outstanding, showed a lot of maturity, and continues to. He's going to stay in the game here. Rod Drew's got a lot of confidence in him. He's going to stay with him, which is great. So, as I was saying, really easy for young kids to lose their confidence. He's just stuck to it and kept pounding the zone, kept going at the hitters, staying aggressive and keeping his team in the game. He's done a really good job.
I like that call, giving him a little bit of confidence with young Barnett stepping in, and also with two out as well. Good opportunity for him to get out of it. I can see down the Solar Energy bullpen that there's a lefty-lefty matchup. Wright fires this one over to Williams, and that's going to fly into center field as well. I thought possibly maybe a lefty-lefty matchup with I'm just trying to get his number. It might be Deacon down the line warming up. I can't really see that far down, but be good to see Bryce get himself out of a little jam here as Dunn's at second.
An aggression again there by Victoria Blue, stealing second base, runner in scoring position. It's with two out again.
Hits this ball hard, and a nice diving play by Riley. What a grab at second base. That's going to feature in the highlight reel. That ball looked like it was going to be up the middle, no doubt, and a nice full stretch diving play. Riley, take a bow. The fans are on their feet giving you a nice little cheer. We're going to throw to a commercial break. We'll be right back for the bottom of the fourth inning. 4-2, Victoria lead Western Australia.
here. Have a nice flight.
Traveling can feel like one big mystery. You're never quite sure what is coming your way. But when you've got an entire company who knows that the most on-time flights are nothing if we can't get your things there too. It's no wonder more people choose Delta than any other airline.
Willow, let's talk about that diving play. Jackson Riley, what a grab at second base. You're going to get an opportunity to catch this on the replay. But a full-length dive at second. Great job by the camera girl, possibly down at third base. It might be Ashley down there, but what a grab.
Yeah, outstanding play. Teams with his back against the wall. Fraser Bryce making pitches there. Runner on second base with two out. That ball gets through. It's a 5-2 ball game. And the momentum goes back Victoria Blues way. Really, really good play. We see him ranging here to his right. Full-length dive by Jackson Riley and snags that ball. We see Dunn. He's already rounding third base when he catches that ball, so there's no chance they're going to throw him out at home plate.
That's a big league play right there, and I love it as he hustles in. It ain't nothing. I do this for breakfast. As he hustles in, as Jack Taylor steps in. First pitch, sees off the plate. Hit the ball hard at the center field last at bat, but it was he sort of dug it out of the ground, didn't he?
Yeah, it was a really good pitch made by Mitchell Wilcox on that, and he had him reaching out in front, but showed the power that he has, and he put some good I was about to say put good wood on it, but put good metal on it and got it out to the center field.
I know the ABL fans that are tuned in this afternoon would have a little chuckle at that, because Taylor takes this one off the knee and gets himself a leadoff hit by pitch. As early in the ABL season, there was something that I was saying a little too regularly, and that was he got good wood on that, and it actually became an ABL drinking game on Twitter. It was very, very big at the start of the season. Every time I'd say, oh, we got good wood on that, that means that everybody at home needed a skull of beer or skull of drink or whatever they were doing, or an ice water or a lemon squash for the young fans.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, that's great. Let's keep that going. It's a hot day out there. I'm sure there's plenty of people tuning in, watching the game by their pools around the countryside. So every time myself or Crosby says good wood, you guys have the freedom to be able to have a swig of your beverage of choice.
Beverage of choice. Good answer. As Mason Talbot steps in, 357 coming into today's game. Taylor, very small lead. This is a hard hit ground ball to Dale. Dale flips at the Barnett, who fires it over to Beatty, but a little bobble at first base and he is safe, but a nice turn almost.
Yeah, really good play there. Good solid play by Jared Dale coming up with that. Good feed over there to second base, and the runner running hard there. Taylor getting in the legs of the second baseman as he's going to turn that ball, and makes a little bit of a low throw. Matt Beatty almost with a pick up there. Always going to be a tough play for him to make that play, but good hustle there by Talbot to get onto first base and one out runner on first.
As Wright steps in, first pitch swinging, that ball's down the third base line. Goodman hustling a long way, but that's going to bounce foul and roll all the way into the Solar Energy bullpen. Wilcox, very impressive on the bump this afternoon.
Yeah, he's worked quickly. He's worked with his catcher, Justin Burke, and gets on the mound, gets the ball, and throws it. He's been attacking the zone and made pitches where he needed to, and he'll be looking to try and get another double play ball and try and get out of the inning. The defense has been outstanding from both teams today, so it looks like you get it on the ground, you better be able to get it through the infield, otherwise you're out.
As you said, the best of the best that Australia has to offer. You're tuned in watching the gold medal game between Victoria and Western Australia, under-16s. These kids certainly have some talent, and plenty of scouts in the audience keeping an eye on the future prospects of not only the ABL, but some possible colleges and big leaguers in the future.
Yeah, definitely. There's been a lot of interest from professional scouts around here. It's great to be able to have the under-16s and under-18s in the same venue.
Yeah.
The scouts have been coming in, and you know, there's... you know, a couple of dozen scouts out here and well over a dozen teams represented. So these young kids are playing obviously for a national championship, but also for an opportunity to get on a national team or to get to college or into professional baseball.
Home plate umpire says strike three to Jet Wright, and he will be the second out.
Really good pitch there. Breaking ball painted the outside corner, and Justin Burke set up right on the outside corner, and Wilcox's breaking ball hit him right in the mid, and no choice for Terry Ford other than to ring him up.
As Jackson Riley steps in and first pitch swing, hits this ball straight up the middle for a base hit, and It's amazing, this sport, Willow. Confidence can make a huge difference. You come up with a big grab like that in the last inning, and you're coming in, you're almost knowing you're hitting this ball.
Yeah, that's it. That's the saying in baseball. A really good play always gets followed by a base hit. And we see Jackson Rollins, the second hit for today. He's come up there, and we saw him in his first at-bat, aggressive driving the ball to right field on a pitch out over the plate. This one's down and in a little bit, and he drives it back up the middle.
Jackson Riley, 455 coming into today. These stats are amazing. Talbot at second and Riley at first, with David John stepping in here with two out. Bottom of the fourth inning. Western Australia down by two. Manager Rod Drew would be very happy to see a base hit here by David John to try and get the rally going and maybe get a couple of runs across here in the bottom of the fourth with a seven-inning game. Outs are running out. Outs are running out.
Yeah.
How's that, eh?
Easy
ten outs to go. So he sees that one inside, and that's going to get by Burke, and the runners are going to advance, and now all of a sudden we've got the tying run at second in Riley.
And Riley looks like he's a pretty good athlete and runs well. So yeah, you look like you're, a base hit by David John right here, and it may be a tied ball game.
You see, it looks like he was three quarters of the mindset saying, get out of the road, and then that last little bit says, oh, maybe I should let it hit me, as it gets by Burke and hits the back net. Big opportunity here. Good hitters count. Swinging, fouls that one off. Takes count, two balls and one.
David John hitting 357 for the tournament. Another WA Heat hitter that's come in and, pardon the pun, but very hot in this game, and the reason why they're in the gold medal game, and you know, it must be a tough ask for the pitching staff against these guys.
Hits this ball hard on the nose out to right field. Piccioni tracking back. Makes a diving play, but it's going to just get out of his glove, and that's going to score two runners. And as we just said, all of a sudden we've got ourselves a tied ball game. That ball was drilled out to right field, Willow.
Yeah, the ball was crushed. He put a really good swing on that one. Got an inside fastball there, and he's drilled it out there. Great effort by Piccioni in right field, and almost came up with a over-the-shoulder diving basket catch to try and get him out of the inning. But as you said, tied ball game right here. We see the swing, and he's going back, and I think this ball was in his glove and may have popped out when he hit the ground.
Wow.
So what a great effort there by the young fella in right field.
That's a great effort. Talbot and Riley score, and John gets himself a two-run RBI double here with two out in the bottom of the fourth, and all of a sudden we've got ourselves a tied ball game as Alex Johnson steps in. Alex Johnson did a great job his last time up to the plate, advancing runners from first and second to second and third with a nice executed bunt, which managed to score two runs in the bottom of the third inning. Now he's got an opportunity to get himself an RBI here with foul tips that one back into the net with John at second.
Yeah, massive team play for the WA Heat earlier in the game with the sack bunt and putting the runners in scoring position there, and they capitalised on that. Good execution there by young Diggins, and had the RBI ground ball, and then Summers come up with a big two-out hit to drive in the second run of the game, and you know, it was a lot of credit to Alec Johnson on that.
As he hits this one down the line, and John's going to round third and comfortably score. Cartwright's going to fire this one into second. Good solid arm out in left field, but he gets himself an RBI double here. Alex Johnson clutches up, and all of a sudden it's a 5-4 ball game. That's a great swing of the stick, Willow.
Yeah, really good at bat there when it counts. Two out, runner on second base, and we see him getting this inside fastball and pulling it down the line. Really good hustle to be able to get to second base on that. Great play by Cartwright getting that ball in, and too quick for him, and he's on second base. We got runner on second base, two out. We see Dan Bertrand coming out to speak with young Mitchell Wilcox, and there's some action in the bullpen, and he's going to stay with him.
How good is it for the right fielder in Alex Johnson? He's been battling all tournament, yet to secure a base hit, and then clutches up here with a double down the line to get his team in front by a run.
Yeah, definitely. It's one of the reasons probably why he's in the gold medal game, and I'm sure that he might not have had the best luck all the way through the tournament and everything, but he's come up clutch and had a good team effort there with the bunt that he put down and helped his team out there, and he comes up himself now, gets his first hit, and drives in a run to be able to put him ahead.
And that ball's hit in the game. gap, and Piccioni take a bow. What a grab in right field. He almost made a spectacular catch over the top of his head that bounces off, but he hustles in here and makes a wonderful grab in right field. You're going to see on the replay, gets a good wood out there, and it looks like it's going to fall in, but a full-length stretch dive, couldn't get any further, and what a grab by Piccioni in right field. That guy has got some skills. We're going to throw to a commercial break, and we'll be right back. 5-4, Western Australia lead Victoria.
Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in 2015 Network?
Barber makes the call, it's all over. In the perfect hit, I've done it.
Top of the fifth, leading off Goodman, then Burke and Piccioni. Piccioni made a spectacular grab in the bottom of the fourth inning to save Victoria, a short run. That boy has some skills out in right field, and he's going to have a little confidence coming into his at-bat.
Yeah, definitely. We saw Jackson Riley get the base hit after his outstanding play up the middle, and time will tell what Piccioni will do, but he's hit the ball well a couple of times so far today.
Goodman, 313 coming into this afternoon's game, led off or got himself a single earlier in this game. He's hitting the ball very, very well, seeing the ball good, and Bryce is still battling here. Coming out in the top of the fifth inning.
Yeah, we talked about him earlier. He's done an outstanding job, kept his team right in the game, done everything that Rod Drew wanted to do. And I'm that sure ball, that,
Balls hit hard on the ground to the second baseman of Riley, fires it over to Taylor, and he's retired.
Yeah, he's kept them in the game, and you know they've got the confidence and a really good offense coming in there. They're off the charts as a team and hitting 359 as a team. And know that time will tell. They're going to score some runs. So if I can keep it close here, I'm going to give my team a chance. And we saw Rod Drew potentially going to take him out, but he stuck with him. And now he's pitching with the lead and a chance to put Victoria Blue back in the dugout and give him a chance to continue to win this game.
And you touched on a little earlier about some of the guys using the BB call bats and others using the bum bats. And as you can see in Justin Burke stepping in here, he's using the bum bat.
Yeah, he's using the bum bat, and a lot of these kids will practice with the bum bats. If they're playing in senior league, they might be forced to use wood sometimes at home. So it comes down to comfort level and what they want to do. So, the BB core bats, they react very similar to wood. But
hits this ball hard on the ground, and it just scrapes by Taylor at first base and out to Johnson in right field, and he gets himself a one-out single.
Yeah, and the sweet spot on the metal bats are probably a little bit bigger than the wooden bats there, and we can see the size of Justin Burke there, and not fair on Damien Shanahan there. Justin's a tall young man and probably standing on the base, so we see Damien Shanahan, who's a long-time Australian national team coach and also a high-performance manager for Baseball Victoria, does a great job, and unfortunately at the stand next to Justin, and Justin had the base to his advantage as well.
He is a tall guy. As manager Rod Drew wants to come out and have a little chat here with one out in the top of the fifth inning. Plenty of movement down in the Solar Energy bullpen. We've got a righty and a lefty warming up down there.
Light swing now, right? Lighten it out.
And manager Drew's going to stick with him. And great to see the confidence in the young man on the bump.
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, he's going with the guy that he thinks is going to give him a chance to win the gold medal here in the national championship game. And been out to see him a couple of times with relievers in the pen and showing enough confidence to be able to stick with him. So interesting to know what kind of his pitch count is and how many he's got left for this game. So
this ball's hit on the ground, a third baseman of Talbot. Talbot fires it to Riley, who fires it over to Taylor. That's a bang-bang play at first base, but a really, really good job by Talbot to get it over to Riley. get the lead runner on that chopping ground ball.
Yeah, we saw it early in the game. He catches the ball, gives Jackson Riley something to handle, and a really good turn getting it over to the first baseman. Taylor is right on the money. Bang, bang, play. Justin Burke does a really good job, as Victoria has, and gets into his legs there, makes it difficult on him, and we see the bang, bang play at first, and really good call there by Ben Nash.
It's a really good play because that ball chopped up a long way. And the third baseman in Talbot was a long way over. It almost was in the shortstop position. And if he had left that for Williams, who had to make a backhand play, he probably wouldn't have been able to make the throw to first base. So a really, really good play as Jesse Hunter steps in here. Piccioni certainly got some wheels, but doesn't go this time. That ball is hit on the nose and finds a gap between Diggins and Summers. Rounding second and heading for third is Piccioni. He's comfortably going to stand up there. There's going to be a bang, bang play at second, and he is safe, not in time. Jesse Hunter's got some wheels, and so does Nathan Piccioni. That's a great bit of baseball right there by the Vicks.
Yeah, very good bit of baseball there. Really nice swing by Jesse Hunter. Drives that ball into left center, and with two out, you don't want to be the third out at third base, but Piccioni backs himself, goes all the way to third base. Really good play by Diggins here, comes up firing to Jesse Williams, redirects the throw to second base. Really close play at second base, but really good baseball all around. We've harped on how good the defense has been. The base running's been outstanding. These kids are playing a heck of a game.
Certainly playing some great baseball as Luke Cartwright steps in here with two runners on, one swing of the bat, and all of a sudden this could be a tied ball game as Drew wants to have a little chat with home plate umpire.
Yeah, Rod Drew's coming out here to chat to the umpire, and not sure what that would be about, but as we see here, Fraser Bryce will try and get his team out of this inning. Runners on second and third with two out. He's pitched out of trouble before, and he's kept his team right in this game. So it's a tough ask here by Cartwright. He's had a fly out, hit by pitch, and comes in this game with a pretty good batting average. So he's looking to be able to try and drive in a run here.
And I think the discussion may have been we're going to throw to the bullpen because we're going to have a pitching change. As Fraser Bryce is done for the game, and Willow, very, very impressive outing. He battled very tough, giving up three runs in the first, but an amazing job to put up a couple of zeros second and third, only giving up one run in the fourth.
Yeah, what an excellent job by a young man there. Obviously, the weight of the world on his shoulders coming in to try and win a gold medal for the WA Heat. And he pitched a really, really good game today. He stuck with it. A little bit of trouble early in the game, but he kept the momentum going for the WA Heat. A couple of really good plays behind him, and he's given his team a chance here to win a gold medal.
Ryan Nuttall comes on from the Solar Energy bullpen. We're going to throw to a commercial break. We'll be right back here with two out, runners on second and third. Big battle here for Ryan Nuttall, who comes on here with two out. First pitch misses outside, and that's going to get by right behind the plate, and that's going to score the tying run in Piccioni. Nuttall comes on, first pitch misses outside, wild pitch right, tries to try and keep that ball in front, but it gets by him, and all of a sudden it's a 5-all ball game.
Good jump there by Piccioni. It's a really short backstop here. You can probably see it on the camera here from at Blue Sox Stadium. It's a short back net. You need to make sure that you get a really good jump to be able to score.
Hard hit ground ball to Riley. Fires it over to Taylor. But the damage has been done in a wild pitch. They score a run. All of a sudden, it's a 5-all ball game. Victoria battling Western Australia here for the gold medal at Blue Sox Stadium. We'll be right back for the bottom of the fifth.
the champions of Australian baseball.
The month of February is fast approaching, and so too is the Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in 2000 at MLB Network?
Summers, Williams and Taylor due up here in the bottom of the fifth inning. It's a five-all ball game if you've just joined us. Under-16s gold medal game between Victoria and Western Australia. Summers bringing a 333 batting average into this afternoon's game for the tournament. First pitch swinging and drills this one foul down the line. Down into the Solar Energy bullpen. Hit that ball on the nose.
Yeah, he's hit a couple of balls hard today. Just missed a double in his first at-bat. He's had an RBI single in his second at-bat, and he's hit that ball really, really well. He's got a couple of stolen bases in the tournament, so him and Jesse Williams are the two guys that have stolen the most of the bases for WA Heat, so he's trying to get on base here.
Puts this ball high into the air, and Cartwright does a good job out in left field. Comfortably camps under that one for the first out. Got one out. It's a tied ball game.
Mitchell Wilcox continues to pound the strike zone here and do a really good job for the Vic Blue team. He's kept them right in the game all game long and doing a great job.
Yeah, he's been very, very impressive on the bump, and we spoke about it earlier in the broadcast. Really gets his job done early and not much time between pitches, just gets the ball, gets set and gets on the mound and does a job, tries to start off, you know, getting in front of the hitters, and obviously in your world, mate, that's incredibly important at this level and all the way through.
Yeah, they preach a lot of the time to young pitchers. There's a good swing by Jesse Williams. It's just foul down there, down the right field line. But a lot of the teaching with young pitchers is to the most important pitch in baseball is strike one.
Yeah.
And we've seen Mitchell Wilcox do that the majority of the game. He's come here. It puts the pressure straight back on the hitters, and it's much easier to hit from a 1-0 or 2-0 count than it is 0-1, 1-1, 1-2.
Misses outside. And how have you enjoyed the tournament so far? I know you're up here in the box and giving us a hand today, which is fantastic. Love sitting here next to you chewing the fat. But how have obviously you've been very busy this tournament.
Yeah, I've had a fair few hats on this tournament. So working for Baseball New South Wales and getting around and seeing the New South Wales Blue Sox, New South Wales Country Blue Sox, and seeing those guys play. But also, too, doing some part-time scouting for Detroit, who I work for, and also in my role as National Team Hitting Coordinator, getting around and seeing some of the young hitters, providing some advice and some feedback on the national team selection. The 18 and under team's got to go to a World Cup qualifier, and we see a little bit of controversy here. I think that Jesse Williams might have been clipped by this pitch, and I think that Rod Drew has asked the umpires to go and have a good look at it.
Yeah, definitely looked like it clipped his shirt, and as you can see on the replay there, it may have. And I guess the little mistake there that's been done by Jesse Williams is you don't hesitate, right? You think it's hit your shirt, just throw the bat and start running up to first, and the decision's been overturned. Manager Drew comes down, has a little chat with home plate umpire. Now there's going to be a little discussion from the Vics.
Yes, tough on the umpires there. If it flicks the shirt, it's you know, a lot easier. And as you said, if Jesse Williams had to flick the bat and headed straight down there, might have made it a little bit easier on him. But to the umpire, Terry Ford's credit, he potentially couldn't have seen it properly. He went and asked the other umpires. One of the guys must have seen it. And Jesse Williams is on first base with one out.
And you mentioned earlier, Jesse Williams has got some wheels, right, as the big Taylor, Jack Taylor, steps in. But big, big lead at first base with a lefty on the mound.
Yeah, big aggressive lead at first base there. We're getting late in the game, tied ball game, and Jesse Williams comes in with 3-for-3 in stolen bases, and a left-handed hitter at the plate. It's going to be tough for Justin Burke to be able to do it. So Mitchell Wilcox, a left-hander, so hopefully he's got a good pickoff move and he keeps him close and keeps him at first base.
Throws over, not in time. That's a nice aggressive lead into this guy. Obviously, he's very confident with his speed and ability to read the pitch. And Wilcox works very, very quickly there, comes to a set. He's not messing around.
No, that's right. And it's probably important for Mitchell Wilcox to do his best to try and hold Jesse Williams close at first base. But the last thing he wants to do is take his attention away from Taylor here at the plate and not execute his pitches properly.
Williams not going anywhere, and that ball is hit hard out to Cartwright in left field, running around in circles, but makes a nice grab. And it's amazing how challenging it can be out in left field here at Blue Sox Stadium. The wind swirls it around and the sun gets in your eyes, and he does a really good job in camping under the fly ball from Taylor.
Yeah, good catch out there by Cartwright. And he's got the sunglasses on, I think, out there, which you need it. The sun sets right behind the first base bleachers here, so that would have been right in his eyes, and a really good play to get in and around it and make that catch.
But it looks on the replay, it looked like Cartwright thought he got a little bit more of it as he hustled back towards the warning track and then doubles back in, does a good job as Mason Talbot steps in. Pitch outside. Interesting to see with a five-all ball game that Williams was not going in that at-bat, Willa.
Yeah, I was surprised that he hasn't run early there and potentially giving chance for the four-hole hitter, left-handed hitter, open lane over there at first base, trying to give him a chance to be able to hit. But, you know, potentially later in this at-bat with Talbot up, who's, you know, got plenty of RBIs in this tournament. He comes in with five, which is a pretty good deal there. If two out, he'll be looking to try and get on second base and give the five-hole hitter a chance to be able to drive in a go-ahead run. There he
takes off. Hit and run, that ball's high into the air. Beattie's tracking down and just cannot camp under that one. Very good jump there. I think he was comfortably in at second if he had not fouled that one off.
Yeah, manager Rod Drew got him in motion there, and good swing by Talbot, but fouled it off there. It was a good pitch. So
I've seen it many a times, even when I'm coaching. In that situation, you almost want to yell out, leave it, you know, because he's got a massive jump. You can see on the replay here. First move, he was going, and he has got some real wheels. Jesse Williams hustling down to second.
Yeah, definitely. And if Talbot hits a double there, it's probably an easy run with a runner in motion.
Williams not going anywhere. Talbot sees that one all the way through and inside. Takes the count 2-2. Two across the board, two balls, two strikes, two out here in the bottom of the fifth inning. A five-all ball game. Jesse Williams at first and Mason Talbot trying to make something happen here with two out. Williams takes off and he is comfortably in the second. And that pitch misses, takes the count full. And all of a sudden, as you said, Willow, Talbot's got an opportunity to get himself his sixth RBI for the tournament.
Yeah, really good jump by Jesse Williams. You talked about the big lead. He takes off right away. Justin Burke with a good release and a good throw. But, you know, Jesse Williams in there in time. And even if the throw's right on the money there, he's going to be safe.
Talbot puts this ball high into the air. Cartwright's going to have to hustle back, but gets a really good read and a really good line on that one. Camps under that one for the third out. We are through five complete. The score is 5-5. We're going to be right back for the top of the sixth inning. Victoria battling Western Australia for the gold medal here in Blue Sox Stadium. Beattie, Dale and Dunn due up here in the top of the sixth inning. And Willow, a five-all ball game. I know it's a little early to talk about extra innings, but share with the fans at home how that works.
Yeah, to keep the participation in the games going and to avoid long games that are going to wear out pitching staffs in the tournament, they go with a tiebreaker rule. So they'll start with the last two hitters of the innings. Yep. We'll start on second and first base, respectively, and at the start of the eighth inning or extra innings.
We've seen, that ball is high and tight inside, and that's a foul ball, but he's going to take it as a hit by pitch. But I'm pretty sure the home plate umpire says, not a chance, mate, that was a foul ball, so back you come.
Yeah, umpire Terry Ford bringing him back here to the plate, calling Matt Beattie back. So it'd be interesting to see on the replay where this ball hit him or if it did hit him or not.
See, he shapes around nice and early, and that ball's high and tight, and just gets
him
in the helmet, on the full, actually. Hits the helmet on the full, doesn't actually touch the bat. And in that situation, that's no doubt a hit by pitch. And you can see him not very happy talking to his third base coach saying, mate, that ball just hit me in the helmet and you're going to tell me to come back and say that that was a foul ball. But now it's really important to see the maturity of the young man try and step up here in Beattie to battle back.
We see an 0-1 count there. So the umpire might have ruled that it hit him, but he might have also ruled that he tried to attempt to bunt that. So
good pick up, Willow.
Not 100% sure what would have happened there, but regardless, he's in there to hit and he's got a 1-1 count.
That ball misses high. And you spoke about the speed up rule in the, or not the speed up rule, but the extra innings. Oh, that ball is hit a little, I thought he hit that well, but that was a little fly ball straight to Riley at second base. Camps under it for the first out. There's been plenty of games here that have gone extra innings, which just shows the talent of these players.
Yeah, it shows the quality of the talent and how close the teams are, and we've seen plenty of the tiebreaker situations, so it's really, really important for the teams to be able to be prepared, know what they're going to do with their bunt plays and be able to execute late in the game, because if you don't execute properly, you're not going to give yourself a chance to win those games. In the tournament of baseball, every win counts.
Jared Dale steps in, sees first pitch for a strike. In fact, we were just speaking off air, the guys that are going to battle for the gold medal game here in the 18s. Western Australia beat New South Wales in extra innings as Dale hits his ball up the middle, gets himself a one-out single. And I believe Western Australia came back to win it in the bottom of the 12th inning.
Yeah.
Plenty of extra innings there, huh?
That's right. Three goes at the tiebreaker rule there. So, yeah, it's one of those things where if games go a lot of extra innings and you've got limited squads and participation rules and time off and all those kind of things, it makes it tough on teams at times there. But we see Jared Dale with a really good swing there, drives the ball in the centre field, and Ryan Nuttall is throwing from kind of a lower angle than you'd usually see for a young player here. Which is
takes off first pitch, Wrights fires that to second, and it's in time, and he is thrown out. And in retrospect to this game, that's a really big play, and I apologise for interrupting, Willow, but that was a really, really nice throw by Wright. Nice pick by Williams, and he's thrown out comfortably.
Yeah, definitely. We see Dale here taking off. Doesn't get the greatest of jump, but Wright picks the ball up, fires it down to second base, right on the money, one hop, and Jesse Williams takes it and tags Jared for an easy out at second base.
That ball is hit high into there to Diggins, out in centre field, got some wheels, comfortably camps under that one, and they end up getting a 1-2-3 here in the top of the sixth inning. We've got ourselves a good battle here. We're going to be back for the bottom of the sixth inning, all locked up, five apiece, Victoria and Western Australia.
Ground ball back at the pitcher. Tola recovers, and Canberra are the champions of Australian baseball.
The month of February is fast approaching, and so too is the Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in 2000 for B Network?
We've had a little visit to the solar energy bullpen. Mitchell Wilcox is done for the afternoon, and a fantastic outing as Lachlan Jack comes on. A really, really impressive performance by Mitchell Wilcox through five complete, giving up five hits to a very, very strong Western Australia team.
Yeah, we talked about their offense coming in with all the hitters, you know, majority of them hitting over 350, and to scatter five hits across five innings in a gold medal game, he was excellent today. Got himself into trouble a couple of times, but pitched out of it, and leaves the game here with a tie. And he'll turn it over to Lachlan Jack to try and keep that going and give their bats a chance to be able to give themselves a lead late in the game here.
And due up is Jet Wright, Jackson Riley and David John here in the bottom of the sixth inning. And really, this is going to be small ball baseball, right? It's really important to make things happen. But anything about the ABL at the moment, mate? Have we got some standings or even some scores? Have you got anything that's happening at the moment?
Yeah, it's really tight in the ABL, obviously, in the last couple of weeks of the season here, and some progress scores in the top of the sixth down in Canberra. The Perth Heat are ahead of the Cavalry there, 9-4. Melbourne and Adelaide are tied nil all, and so are Sydney and Brisbane.
It's unbelievable how close it is in the top of the lead standings at present. I think three or four teams are tied at second or third.
Yeah, three teams tied for third, and Adelaide clinched first place last night. And
as leadoff man, he hits this one down the line, and that's going to go fair. He's rounding first and not going to go anywhere. He's going to hold up, almost trips over the first baseman of Beattie, but does a great job in getting himself a leadoff single here in the bottom of the sixth inning.
Yeah, good swing by Wright here. He gets a fastball out over the plate, drives it down the left field line. Really nice play by Cartwright to get that ball in, and the outfielders have done a great job by showing some closing speed and getting the ball straight back to the cutoff man and preventing that runner from being on second base.
Yeah, Cartwright's been very, very impressive in left field. He's had plenty of work to get done. And as you mentioned, it's just so important that you hit the cutoff to try and keep them 90 feet closer. And they've done a really good job here. And I think it just shows how great the coaching staff have worked these guys to ensure they execute on the simple stuff.
Yeah, these guys are volunteers a lot of the time, and they put in so much time and effort to try and help these kids out, both at practice and during the tournament.
Oh, Wright takes off, and Riley shapes around a bunt. And nice effort by Burke behind the dish, but just misses it.
Yeah, Rod Drew gave Jackson Riley the first pitch of this at-bat to swing at. He's been red hot. A couple of singles up the middle. Really nice play there. And he goes 1-0 and puts the bunt on him there. So he attempted to bunt there, fouled it off. So we got a 1-1 count here. And it'll be interesting to see where Rod Drew goes, whether he wants him to sack bunt, whether he's going to let a guy that's swinging a really hot bat try and drive a ball and have first and second and keep the inning going.
It's a really good point, and they're going to let him swing away, and that ball is hit hard to Goodman. Goodman fires it over to Barnett, who fires it over to Beattie, and that's a nice 5-4-3 double play. And really, really interesting point, and probably a great discussion point, Willow, is in that situation, being so late in the game, bottom of the sixth inning, really you're only one inning away from this ball game being over with a runner on first. You really want to do everything you can to get him to second, but the way that Jackson Riley's been swinging the stick, coming in here with a 455 batting average, you almost want to just, obviously, he just wanted to risk it to see whether he can drive the ball in the alley.
Yeah, everyone's got their different opinions on it, and a lot of the time, if you're managing games, you have to go by feel. And he comes in the game, 455 average, he's got a couple of hits so far, and sometimes you go with your gut feeling, and he hit that ball pretty well, but he hit it straight at the third baseman into a double play. It goes 3 or 4 feet to either side, and we've
and
got first
and,
yeah, first and third, and you look like a genius. So you go with your gut there, and Jackson Riley put a good swing on that, but really good defense again by Vic Blue and turning a great double play in a pressure situation.
David John hits this ball hard down the right field line and hooking foul just into the Solar Angie bullpen. That ball actually got out of the stadium. He did not miss that one, and he didn't miss it earlier on too when he got himself a two-run RBI double later in this game.
Yeah, he had a really good at-bat and drove the ball out there. Pitch only made a really good play, but popped out of his glove when he hit the deck there, and that's a really good swing. The WI have hit some balls really hard today, just foul down the right field line there, so they're peppering that, all these left-handed hitters.
David John puts this ball hard on the ground. Barnett at second. Little bobble, still in time to Beattie. And they retire the side. And a big momentum shift there, getting that 5-4-3 double play. We're going to be back for the top of the seventh inning. All locked up, five apiece. Vic versus Western Australia here at Blue Sox Stadium, battling for the gold medal.
Ground ball back at the pitcher. Tola recovers, and Canberra are the champions of Australian baseball.
The month of February is fast approaching, and so too is the Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in 2 Network?
Welcome back to Blue Sox Stadium here at Blacktown International Sports Park. We're back top of the seventh inning. Victoria ready to battle. They're in the meat of the lineup. Their leadoff man of Barnett, Goodman and Burke, even Piccioni in the four hole. Victoria would love to see Piccioni get in here to be able to continue the way he's been playing today. He's on fire, hitting 529 for the tournament. Try and get some runs aboard here as it's all locked up for our fans at home. This is a seven-inning ball game, so this is the last inning of regulation.
Jordan Barnett's had a really good day today. Led off the game with a double, put the pressure on the WA Heat, and he's had hit a couple of line drives. Really good play by Taylor at first base to double off the runner early in the game. I think it was Jack Dunn, and then the great play by Jackson Riley up the middle on a line drive. So he's hit the ball hard three times today.
And catcher Wright wants to go out and have a little chat. He's got a very interesting style, doesn't he, Willa?
Yeah, he throws from a bit of a lower angle there, and you know, like, it's not potentially a traditional way of teaching players to throw, but if he feels comfortable from down there, and a lot of the time it comes down to body angle on where the arm angle sits. So you see he leans over there and he throws from a bit of a lower angle. He's got a bit of movement, and four-pitch walk there for Jordan Barnett to start off the inning.
And that's exactly what Victoria would want here. And this will be interesting to see what happens, whether he's going to be on the bike with his wheels or whether they're going to play the small ball and look for Goodman to put a bunt down.
Yeah, it's a tough one here for Dan Bertrand to see how he'd do it. I'm assuming that he'll probably sack bunt here after the great throw by Jet Wright to throw out Dale in the last inning. So probably puts a little bit of a dent in your confidence. You know, if you put the runners there in motion and you know, Jet Wright comes up and hoses one of your runners last inning. So we see the sack bunt there. He squared around and fouled it off, so we'll see what happens here.
And Rod Drew's got his third baseman in Talbot standing very, very shallow on the grass. Certainly wants to get a good read here. And in this situation, Willow, you're probably trying to throw the ball a little high in the air to see whether he can pop this up. As he puts this ball on the ground, it's going to be a play at first base, and that ball's going to get thrown away, and there's going to be safe everywhere. They're going to round him at third and head him for home, and no, he's going to hold him up. And we might get a chance to see that replay, but Riley, who's covering from second base, dove to get that ball and elbowed Goodman right in the face. And I guess that's why we're going to have a little timeout here. Barnett comfortably advances to third base, but you're going to see on the replay, good little bunt, gets a lot of bounce, and this ball's a little confusion at first. He throws that ball high. Riley jumps to catch that ball, and that right elbow just gets him right in the face. Pushes him down. There was no intention there at all. But Nuttall is done for the afternoon. We're going to throw to the Solar Energy bullpen, and all of a sudden the Vicks have got a good opportunity here to battle in the top of the seventh inning with runners on the corners. We're going to throw to a commercial break. We're going to be right back.
Yeah.
Number 19, Lachlan Southie, comes on here with a really sticky situation with a lefty-lefty matchup with Justin Burke coming in. Runners on the corners, Barnett and Goodman. Barnett led off with a four-pitch walk from Nuttall. And Goodman put a bunt down with a wild throw into right field. Barnett comfortably advanced to third, and Goodman is standing at first. And Burke facing first pitch. He takes off, and he's going to comfortably go into second. And interesting to see that he threw that ball then. There was definitely no play. Goodman got a really nice jump, and they were very, very lucky in that situation that ball didn't run into the outfield, into Diggins, and Barnett scores from third.
Yeah, really good backing up there by the middle infielders. Jet Wright made a really good throw. Runner coming in there at the same time, and backing up that throw didn't get into center field.
Infielders playing on the grass. And ball's in the dirt. Wright does a good job keeping that ball in front. Runners hustle back hard. The mums and dads in the audience will be biting their fingernails right now, Willow. They're enjoying a wonderful afternoon of baseball.
Well, yeah, this is what it comes down to. They've been driving their kids around like we talked about. They paid plenty of money for them to come and play here. And they're watching the gold medal game, and they're probably just as nervous, if not more nervous, than the kids. And Vic Blue with the heart of the order up now. Justin Burke, the three-hole hitter, up with runners in second and third and nobody out.
And Southie comes on here battling. One ball and two strikes. Would really love to be able to support his team in keeping him off balance and hitting his spots, and just misses that ball. Maybe up and in to Burke. Takes the count 2-2.
Yeah, young lefty with a really good breaking ball. He throws it right there, and we see that pitch just missing inside. A lot of break on
Jeez.
That one.
And, yeah, that thing fell out of the sky.
Tough one for Justin Burke to stay in on there, but good call by the umpire. Just missed.
Same pitch. And just misses up again. Really backs himself with that curveball.
Yeah, these pitchers must have a lot of confidence in Jet Wright there back behind the plate. They've got no trouble throwing a breaking ball with runners on third base. We've seen it before, and he's done a great job behind the plate today, blocking, keeping runners from third base from scoring.
Three balls, two strikes, same pitch, misses high and inside, and he loads him up for the very dangerous 529 hitting Nathan Piccioni, who's played a fantastic game in right field, as manager Drew wants to come out and have a little chat.
Yeah, we've seen him with the RBI double earlier in the game. We've seen him with the almost brilliant catch there on David John's RBI double, and then the catch to end the inning. And he's been red hot this tournament, 529 coming in there. So he'd be confident, as you said, seeing it like a beach ball, and ready to try and do some damage here with bases loaded, nobody out.
I think they may have brought Southie in just for that lefty-lefty matchup with Burke, and it looks like Southie may be done for the evening, and he is. He's come on to face one hitter, and they're going to the bullpen down in left field. And we'll just give you a number when we get a chance. And we talk about baseball and how statistics and matchups work. You know, obviously you would have seen it a lot as a lefty-lefty matchup. The splits are significantly different when a left-handed hitter is facing a left-handed pitcher.
Yeah, definitely. They get a chance to see a lot of left-handers there. So what they'll try and do is bring a left-hander in to face a left-handed hitter and try and get that breaking ball. And we see that young Southie had a really good breaking ball. He just missed three times in a row there to Justin Burke, who's a dangerous left-handed hitter, and did the right thing there. Rod Drew did the matchups there. He probably told the young fella to come in there and you know, don't try and attack the zone. Make him swing at your pitch. He went there with his breaking ball there, threw two or three good ones, just missed, and yeah, that's the way it goes.
Yeah, really good point you make. As the DH man himself, David John, comes on to try and get him out of a jam, the last thing you want to do is just sit one over the plate. With loaded bases, good opportunity to turn a double play. No doubt everyone will be playing in to try and get the lead runner, but a force out here is a much easier play than a runner on second and third.
Yeah, that's right. It's always tough as a manager to be able to look at those pressure situations. You've already got a couple of runners out there. It's a tied ball game, and stick someone out there at first base. But as you said, it creates some options defensively to where a hard hit ball here with the infield in might mean no runs and a couple of outs on a double play through there. But it also makes it tough on the defense, because they talk about hitters' averages going up 100 points when the infield's in. So if you've got young Nathan Piccioni here coming in hitting 529 with the infield in, he might be at 629. So they're in a bit of a bind, the WA Heat, and hopefully David John can come in and make some pitches, and we'll see how we go.
And interesting to see Summers is playing almost on the warning track as first pitch swinging, drills that ball into left field. Barnett's going to score. Goodman's going to get held up. And all of a sudden, it's a 6-5 ball game. First pitch, Piccioni gets after it, puts the ball on the ground, does the job he needs to do, and gets himself an RBI single here with none out, keeps the loaded bases.
And that's the pressure we see on the defense with the infield in. It takes away from range, and that ball might have gotten through, but with the third baseman in on the grass and the shortstop in on the grass, Jess Williams, it gets between both of them, and that's why the averages go up by so much. It takes away from range, and a good swing from the red-hot Nathan Piccioni.
First pitch swinging again. That's going to hook foul down the right field line. Piccioni, very, very impressive today. Goodman at third, Burke at second, Piccioni at first as Jesse Hunter.
Doubled last at bat with some good base running as well. Aggressive on the bases. So WA's come in with a red-hot offense, and obviously Vic Blue's got a good offense as well, but they've really swung the bats well today.
Nice breaking ball, swing and a miss for strike two. David John got a little pop on that fastball as well. You can hear it up here in the booth. Working very quickly, 0-2, same pitch. This is going to be a throw from Williams to right at home plate, fires it to first. And there's a little bobble at first, and he is safe. And that's a little unfortunate, Jake Taylor. Looks like he tried to almost get out of the road at first base, but that was a really, really nice play from Williams and by Wright.
Yeah, mature heads-up play by Jesse Williams there. Picks the ball up, hits Jet Wright right on the... It's coming down the line. Yeah. They've got to stay in the line there. And, you know, Jet made a really good throw, but you've got a lot of things going on. So tough play for Taylor there, and we're back in the same situation.
And he hits this ball into right field. Cartwright's going to get himself at least one, possibly two. Piccioni got wheels, not in time at home, and he gets himself a two-run RBI single here in the top of the seventh inning, and all of a sudden, Victoria are taking this game away.
Yeah, he's played some great defense today. We've talked about him making all those catches in left field. Some really good throws, and he comes up here in a pressure situation. Bases loaded, infield in, gets a fastball there and drives it through the gap. Dan Bertrand really aggressive there with the runner coming in from second base. Close play at the plate, well executed, and really good job there. Two RBI single.
If that ball is on the money at home, it was going to be a really, really tight play. But we've spoken about all day ensuring that you hit your cuts, and they've done that beautifully today. A really, really great job. Piccioni certainly got some wheels, and a great job by Cartwright. That pitch was up and in. He managed to just get inside that baseball and drill it out to right field and picks himself up a couple of RBIs. But it's not over yet. There's one out. And David John having a little trouble here, trying to get himself and his team out of a bit of a jam, and Wright's doing a really good job behind the plate, keeping that ball in front.
Yeah, he's been very tidy back there. And the key here for the WA Heat is to not try and get too far ahead of themselves, just keep their composure, try and get into the back in the dugout and build an inning at the bottom of the inning here.
Just misses low and outside.
Victoria swung the bats great coming in today. We see that's their 12th hit today, and you know, all the way through the lineup, everyone's done their job and driven in some runs in some really big situations.
Hunter at second, Cartwright at first. Beattie battling here with two balls and one strike. Sees that pitch low and inside. Takes the count 3-1, and David John finds himself in a little hole here. 3-1. I was trying to find him on the scorecard, and I appreciate you pointing him out, Willow. I didn't realize he was the DH man coming in. Don't usually see that as he misses high and inside. And that's a five-pitch walk to Beattie and loads him up here with one out.
Yeah, good at bat by Beattie there. He's a young fella with some power and can get overawed in that situation. He didn't try to do too much, didn't chase the pitches there, and David John did a good job. He doesn't want to just lay one in there for him, and now we've got bases loaded again. The middle's playing back. They're looking to turn a double play. We've seen a fair few double plays today, so David John's job here is to try and pound the bottom third of the zone and get the ball on the ground.
It's a good pitch. Strike one. Big swing and a miss by Jared Dale here with one out.
Yeah, it was a really good swing there by young Jared. His older brother Ryan's got some power and looks to drive the ball out of the ballpark, and I think he was trying to emulate his brother there and try and make a four-run swing of it.
He puts this one on the end of the bat. It's going to loop out and land and score. He's going to try and take second base. That's a wild throw, and that ball's going to get all the way, and I think this may score plenty of runs. One comes in, two comes in, rounding second, heading for third. He's going to hold him up. Three runs have scored. BD Cartwright and Hunter clear the bases. And Dale ends up on third, and all of a sudden it's a 10-5 ball game. You chase runners, you throw it away. Unfortunately, you're going to bound to score some runs.
Yeah, we see Ryan Dale here. Look at that swing. That ball's almost on the ground. Jet Wright goes down to block that ball. Base hit and a base running mistake there by Beattie has actually come to good fortune for Vic Blue. He thought the ball was going to be caught. He came back to first base there, and they cut it, tried to throw him out at second, and the ball got away.
First pitch swinging foul, and Taylor did a good job being in the right position for the first baseman. Does a great job taking the cut, but unfortunately, a little excited on that throw, throws the ball back into center field, and Diggins has to turn around and chase after the ball that he just threw in. And Victoria score 5 here in the top of the 7th inning. There's still only one out. David John, unlucky there. That was a really good pitch, but Jared Dale did a great job just keeping his weight back and getting just enough to get over the center field, or in front of the center fielder, I should say, and that brings Jack Dunn in. Hits this ball hard on the ground down the third base line. It gets past Talbot and rolls out to Summers. He's going to try and stretch this into a double, and he's got some speed and comfortably gets himself an RBI double here with one out in the top of the 7th inning. Jack Dunn really drilled that one and getting a couple of hits tonight.
Yeah, he's had 3 hits now and a couple of RBIs, a stolen base. He's had a heck of a game there, Jack Dunn. And we talk about the averages. We've talked about how you can have really good tournaments coming in and tough ones. And, you know, he's done a great job to kind to shake off maybe some nervousness and to shake off some disappointment from a 0.91 average coming in, and he's gone out and peeled off three hits and a few RBIs and had a big game for Vic Blue.
He's been very, very impressive, as the entire lineup for Victoria and Western Australia have. There's been 20 hits so far this game, so the boys have certainly been swinging the bats, and the score is 12-5 Victoria over Western Australia. And the leadoff man in Jordan Barnett getting after that one, fouls that one back, takes the count 2-2.
1-1, I believe.
Yeah, 1-1.
I'm not sure if the scoreboard, they fix it up, so we'll back that we're right. So hopefully he hits that one and we won't have to find out.
How should I ever doubt Craig, who's downstairs? He never makes mistakes, that guy. He's the man. Thank you for all your work, Craig. Doing a great job here this afternoon on your day off. For the love of the game, 2 balls, 1 strike here with one out to Barnett. Vic have just jumped out here in the top of the 7th inning. Big crooked number. 7 runs scored in the 7th. You see that one happening?
Yeah, it's been a tight game, and probably the 12-5 scoreline right now, if you're just tuning in, probably doesn't reflect how tight this game has been the whole way through. So, you know, young men making some young men mistakes there, and you know, some other Vic Blue putting plenty of pressure on the WA Heat. But this game's not over yet, and anything can happen. You know, Vic Blue comes out and rolls out a 7 spot. They'll be trying to get some more runs here because, you know, Dan Bertrine and you know, the Vic Blue staff are probably thinking, you know what, this game's not over with. And WA Heat have got a really, really good offense coming in, hitting 360 or so as a team, so you know, this game is definitely far from over.
Certainly never over until the umpire says time and game. In a big battle here, they have Western Australia trying to get out of this jam. There's only one out. Williams is keeping Dunn very close at second base as Barnett fouls that one back, and the count remains the same, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Seen some fantastic talent both offensively and defensively, Willow, all day.
Yeah, some great plays in the field, some really hard-hit balls, but I've been impressed by the quality of the at-bats that the hitters have been throwing out there. Even some of the outs, we've had plenty of hard-hit balls, some line-outs, and some balls hit deep into the outfield.
Balls hit high in the air to Riley at second base. Camps under that one comfortably for the second out. And Barnett is retired for the second out here. Is Western Australia boys have got a big battle on their hands, down by 7 runs, 1 out to get, as Cooper Goodman steps in here to try and keep the rally alive. 3:13 coming into tonight's game. Tonight. It's today, right?
Feels like tonight.
Feels like tonight. It certainly does. It's been a long day already coming down from sunny Sawtell. Beautiful day up there today. Not as hot as what it is out here. It's really hot. And one thing we need to touch on is right behind the dish. We know we've spoken about him and how well he's played, but that's very, very hot out in that gear on a hot afternoon here in Blacktown.
Yeah, definitely. The catchers do it tough on any of these hot, humid days with all that extra gear on, and so do the umpires.
Goodman hits this ball hard on the ground and bobbles straight through Riley. He's going to round first and head for second. No, he doesn't. He comes back and Dunn comfortably scores from second. And when the floodgates open, Willow, they certainly open up. And the Victoria Blue team here have just been outstanding in the top of the seventh, punching up 8 runs.
Yeah, they've put up 8 runs and a few mistakes from the WA Heat here in this inning have made it tough on themselves. But, you know, continue to go out there and you know, make sure that they've put pressure on these hitters and pressure on the fielders, and hit the balls hard and they've put plenty of pressure on these guys. We see Justin Burke up here, the catcher for the Vic Blue team here, stepping in, and he's had a pretty good day at the plate. He's had a couple of hits and a couple of walks, so he's 2 for 2 coming in and had a walk in the inning there off some tough breaking balls from Southie that he took to keep this inning going. Swung on and driven into left field, and Summers back and takes a catch, and that'll end the inning for the Vic Blue, and they'll head into the bottom of the seventh trying to win a gold medal, up 13-5.
A big battle for Western Australia. Victoria put up 8 runs here in the top of the seventh inning. We'll be right back for the bottom of the seventh. Big battle on the Western Australia front.
The month of February is fast approaching, and so too is the Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in 2N and MLB Network?
Welcome back to Blue Sox Stadium here, Blacktown International Sports Park. Bottom of the seventh inning. Big battle for Western Australia to try and get some runs back. A little bit of a blowout all of a sudden, but it certainly hasn't been like that all game, Willow. 13-5 scoreline does not clearly reflect how this game has been played.
Yeah, if you're just tuning in, it's the 8 runs there in the top of the seventh was... you know, it's kind of blown it out a little bit. The game's definitely not over, as we've spoken about, but it's been a really tough fought contest here. And, you know, the WA Heat have had a really good tournament. They've got a great offense, and it's up to Lachlan Jack to try and shut them down.
As Alex Johnson steps in, sees first pitch off the plate. And as much as a commentator can't be biased, and especially being a New South Wales boy, you know, there's no real lenience to any team, but we'd certainly love to see the Heat come back and battle here, because they really deserve to have this a very close ball game.
Yeah, they'd like to be able to see it a little bit closer than it is, and you know, the scoreline doesn't reflect how the game has been played, but, you know, knowing Rod Drew, knowing what Steve Fish would have installed in these WA Heat kids, and, you know, having seen the Perth Heat play for years and years and years, and their heroes, these guys, that's one thing that Perth Heat, the senior team does, they do not give in, so I guarantee that these kids will go out there swinging.
As you said, the future of the ABL are these kids coming through the ranks, and looking like we're in good shape with these talented young athletes coming through as that ball gets a little away from Jack and misses behind Johnson, runs into the back net to Count two and two.
It's exciting to see that. I've seen a lot of national championships over the past 6 years working for Baseball New South Wales, and there's plenty of players that I've seen come through the under-16s, the likes of a Sam Kennelly and a Zach Shepherd and Louis Thorpe and Daryl George, you name it, all the young players that are coming through in the ABL now playing for all the teams across the country. You've seen these national championships, and you know they're playing for their junior teams, their states, representing their states, but they're definitely the future of our game. And you know, it's wouldn't surprise me to see, you know, in 3 or 4 years' time, the likes of, you know, some of these kids are on the field now out there for the ABL teams.
Puts this ball on the ground at Goodman. It's going to be a big play, and he fires it over to first base in Beattie, and that's a really, really nice play. That was a tough play. The ball bounced and bobbled around. Johnson was hustling down the line, but a really strong throw by Goodman to get him out.
Yeah, really good play, and pretty important for Vic Blue to get that first out. So they get the leadoff runner on, and it puts a little bit more pressure on him, but a really good play there by Goodman, firing across to Beattie and getting by a step. Really good hustle there by Alec Johnson, though.
Now we're back to the leadoff for Western Australia. Chase Diggins sees first pitch. Ball inside. He's been impressive all tournament, 467 coming into today's. He's obviously got some great skills playing centre field, got some really good wheels and great range out there.
Yeah, really athletic looking, tall and lean, and he's moved great in the outfield today, played some really good defence, strong throwing arm, and from the games that I've seen earlier in the tournament, he's hit some balls hard, definitely.
Lachlan Jack, come on, dealing here as he misses right behind the head of Diggins. Does a good job getting out of the road, but he's been pretty impressive. Come on, obviously a lot more relaxed and a lot more comfortable. Now he's got a nice cushy lead, as you see on the replay, just behind Diggins' head.
Yeah, he's done an excellent job. He went, gave up a leadoff hit in the last inning, then got the double play and a 4-3 to end the inning, and got another ground ball to start this inning.
This is that pitch outside in the dirt. Burke's done a good job all game long, trying to keep the ball in front, especially in this heat. Counts 3 balls and 1 strike. 2 outs away from a gold medal. Victoria Blue. Ball's hit on the nose out to right field, and that's going to land and get a little past Piccioni. Rounds first. Nice aggressive. It comes back. Piccioni, he's a great talent, right? He not only can run, not only can he swing the stick, but geez, he can read a ball, and he's got a nice solid arm in right field.
Yeah, he's made some great plays out there today. He robbed Chase Diggins last time of a base hit with that great diving play coming in. That ball's hit hard down the line. He gets it, spins, and fires it straight to the cutoff man in Barnett, and keeps that to a single.
Dawson Summers steps in here with one out. First pitch off the plate outside, ball one. Big aggressive lead by Chase Diggins. You may hear in the microphone that we've got a dog that's making some serious noise out here. They're trying to calm him down, and umpire's going to call timeout, and hopefully the owner of the dog can go and give him a hot dog and calm him down. Oh, that's a terrible punt. Not a hot dog. I mean, you want to give him a burger or a biscuit or a cold drink. But that dog was making some serious noise, and they're going to get the dog out of here. Jeez, that wasn't even thought of. That just flew out of my mouth. Oh, get yeah. That guy a hot dog. You know why I thought that? Because I could go with a hot dog right now with some tomato sauce. I would love that, just in case anybody in the clubhouse can hear what I'm saying. I would love a hot dog up in the booth.
That would be great. I could go for one of the chicken schnitzel burgers that they've been cooking down at Cracker Jack. So if anyone's tuning in that's in close vicinity, fire them up here to the booth.
I really love Mike from Widows. He always tunes in. Even when he's working, he has it playing down in the pizza shop. And we might mention that on the broadcast, and then all of a sudden in 15 minutes' time, someone delivers us a Meat Lover's pizza. So we love the fact that they're tuned in. Delivers. Just misses low, and Summers battles here, and he's ahead 2-0. Good opportunity here to get a good pitch to hit.
WA Heat, as we talked about, they keep grinding out their at-bats. They keep doing that, and Eight runs is a lot of runs to be able to get, so it's important for Lachlan Jack just to, you know, continue to go right at the hitters, make pitches, not try and be too fine. And they're holding the runner on there at first base. They're trying to turn a double play here for the gold medal. And but the credit to the WA Heat kids. It's tough being eight runs down, but they are out there. And Chase Diggins had a really good at bat. Alex Johnson had a good at bat and hustled. And we see the same thing here from Summers.
That ball misses high, takes count 3-1. Interesting to see Barnett at second playing way up the middle, giving a very, very big hole for a lefty out to right field. But maybe that's where Summers likes to hit, likes to push the ball.
Yeah, a lot of the teams will come out there. They'll send the players who might be starting the next day to do some spray charts and try and get as much information as possible. So they'll be playing up there for a reason. And just like their counterparts in the older ABL clubs who do all their work and try and do their scouting, they're trying to get as much information as possible. And hopefully they're positioning someone. And if Summers hits it right here, and then Dan Petrine and his staff will look like geniuses and they'll have a gold medal.
Lachlan Jack battling here. Three balls, two strikes, hits his spot. He's done a really good job to come back. He was a long way behind Summers and manages to take this count full. Really likes to hit that outside pitch.
Yeah, his ball's got some movement on it, moving down away from the lefties. He's had plenty of ground balls since he's come in here, and that was a really good swing there by Dawson Summers, 3-2, really aggressive.
Puts this ball high into the air, done out in centre field, plenty of time. Camps under that one for the second out. And Victoria are one out away from a gold medal here at Blue Sox Stadium in Western Australia. Have got a big battle on their hands with two out.
You see a visit here to the mound from the pitching coach going out to talk to his young pitcher here. So try and keep him calm. They're one out away from that gold medal. And as we said, they got a bit of a really handy lead here and should be comfortable. And I'm sure that all the players and all the staff are starting to get a little bit excited about it. As we see here, Dawson Summers takes a really good swing on that pitch up and out over the plate and puts a good aggressive swing on it, a fly ball to centre field. And the defence has been outstanding today from both teams, and especially the outfield defence dealing here with the tough skies here at Blue Sox Stadium.
And manager Drew having definitely a discussion with the home plate umpire. With two out, runner at first. Chase Diggins, leadoff man, he's aboard at first. As Jesse Williams steps in here, that ball misses high and outside. Runs into the back net, and Chase Diggins comfortably advances to second. Jesse Williams got an opportunity to get himself an RBI here with two out.
Coming in with a hot bat, and you know, we've seen him play some great defense. So, you know, he'll be out there grinding out at bats. He swung the bat well today, had a couple of flyouts, and he was hit by pitch. So, we saw him steal a base in a key situation for them later in the game there. And yeah, be trying to keep it going here for the WA Heat.
Interesting to see how far Burke's setting up outside. Every pitch, he set up a long, long way outside. Two pitches have missed off the plate. That pitch is off the plate as well. I know we're on a little different angle than the cameras and where you guys are sitting in your lounge chair at home in front of the air conditioning, but from where I look, it looks like he's sitting off the plate, but I'm sure he's just sitting on the outside edge. He misses that pitch outside as well, and it's four straight pitches for balls all off the plate outside.
The only thing I can think of there is potentially with the participation rules in these tournaments, there's a certain amount of minimum outs that pitchers have to be able to reach to make sure that they hit their participation limits. So potentially we might be one out away. If he pitches to Jesse Williams, he gets an out there and he doesn't reach their participation, it could come back to haunt the team. But they're going to go right at Taylor here, so it looks like that they're might be on track. I saw it happen a couple of years ago when New South Wales Country won the bronze medal in the 16s. The pitcher out there is one out from his participation rules. They hit a ground ball, they had to hold the ball so he could throw the next hitter. Got the next hitter out and away they go. So maybe it's to do with the participation.
Wow, so it shows that it's a lot more than just putting the best team out there to get the win. You need to make sure you get your defensive outs and your innings and everything else up so that everyone gets a good opportunity to show their skills as a foul ball rolls into left field, but they're not going to see it, so it's going to be play on, and a big swing and a miss by Jack Taylor.
Yeah, and they're one pitch away from it. Yeah, it makes it really tough on the coaches, and you know, those rules are in place to make sure everyone gets a fair go. But if you run into some maybe mercy rule games, you don't play the innings where you can, you know, potentially have all your pitching rotation, everything planned out, it makes it a little bit tough on the coaches. So it's another thing that they deal with, and it's all about trying to make sure that everyone gets a fair go, and you know, all the staff across the board are doing what they can to make sure these kids are getting a crack.
And that's good too, right? They pay their money, they come away, they want to get the opportunity to play the game that they love, and the rules are in place, as you said, to give these kids a fair opportunity. And interesting pickup that you made there, because I was thinking he almost looks like he's intentionally walking the guy because he was set up way outside. Glad you're up here, and I wasn't up here by myself. I wouldn't have a clue. That ball is hit on the nose out to centre field. Dunn hustling in, but it's going to land. All the runners are going to be held up, and Jack Taylor gets himself a nice single up the middle to try and keep the two-out rally here alive as Mason Talbot steps in. And this would be incredible if there's a way they could battle back. As you see on the replay, Jake Taylor gets a nice swing on that and hits the ball up the middle. And I'd love to see Taylor hit a fastball up and in, because I reckon he could hit this one out of the ballpark. He is a very big guy.
Yeah, he's a strong young man, and we've seen him hit a couple of balls hard today. Some hard foul balls as well. So put a really good swing on that with two strikes and line drive to center field.
Talbot steps in, sees first pitch for a ball. Good job by Burke behind the plate to keep that one in front.
Both catches have been tidy today and right for the WA Heat, and Justin Burke have done a great job blocking balls and working really, really hard in the heat with all the gear on and all those things.
Lachlan Jack misses outside. Ball two, gets behind here. 2-0. Really great hitters count for Talbot. Wright sets up over the middle of the plate and misses high. Three balls. You're getting him to hold the bat here, or you're giving him a green light?
Yeah, I would get him to take a pitch right here and try and keep the inning going.
Sees that pitch just hits the outside corner for strike one. And you're right, no doubt that's what manager Drew was saying. Track that in, three balls, one strike, two out. One out away for Victoria, getting themselves a gold medal here at the Under-16s Championships. That ball is hit out to right field. Beattie's chasing that one. That's going to bounce foul.
You can see all the Vic Blue young players there. They're up on the top step of the dugout, and no doubt they're excited for potentially what will happen if they get this final out and win a gold medal. So we talked about the hard work that the parents put in by getting them around, the hard work the staff put in, but you know, it's one thing where it's the most important thing going on in these kids' lives right now,
and
you can tell how excited they are. So they can't wait for the last out here and to race onto that field.
School holidays, they're living the dream. That ball is hit hard on the nose to Cartwright, but he camps under it. And Victoria win themselves a gold medal here at Blue Sox Stadium in Blacktown International Sports Park. Lachlan Jack gets swamped on the mound, and the boys are going crazy, and the fans are on their feet. A great display of baseball here. Willow, I'm sure you would agree, a real battle through six complete innings. It was a five-all ball game, and then Vic just battling the top of the seventh, scoring eight runs, getting the win 13-5.
Yeah, they kept putting pressure on each other all game, a back-and-forth game, and some outstanding defense throughout, some outstanding pitching, and some quality at-bats. As we see there, 22 hits across the board. The bats were really firing today, and you know, the pressure finally got to the WA Heat in the end there, and Vic Blue scored eight in the top of the seventh, and that was always going to be tough to come back from. But to WA Heat's credit, the boys came out there in the last inning and they got bases loaded, and you know, even that last swing there, Talbot put a really good swing on that, hit a really hard line drive straight down Cartwright's throat, who's been outstanding in left field today, and WA end up coming away with a silver medal, which they should be really proud of. They've had a great tournament, and you know, someone has to be the national champion, and unfortunately someone has to finish second.
Certainly a game of inches, this one. Many things could have gone another way, and it would have been an entirely different ball game, or a much closer ball game. But you can see the young men shaking hands after a really good battle all tournament long. Can't say enough about Mitchell Wilcox. He did a great job on the bump, throwing five complete, a really, really good effort. But a couple of the guys that really stood out for me, with Piccioni out in right field, made some outstanding grabs. Cartwright seemed to swing the bat really good. Even Barnett, Goodman, Burke, they all seemed to hit the ball really, really impressive. And one thing that was really important, I think, in this game is to hit through nine. And I think Beattie, Dale and Dunn, they did a really good job in the 7-8-9 hole.
Yeah, definitely. They kept the pressure going. We talked about the top of both of the lineups and WA Heat having all those hitters hitting over 350. But all the way through the lineup, the Vic Blue was outstanding today. Jack Dunn coming in, having not the best tournament so far, and peeling off three hits and driving in a bunch of runs and playing great defense in center field was great. Dale there with a couple of hits, and you know, they just kept the pressure on, you know, all the way through the lineups. Both teams did. So credit to the coaching staff, and credit to the parents, and you know, most of all, a credit to the kids. They've done an outstanding job, and we see the Vic Blue boys there gathering around for photos, and that means a lot to them. And you know, some of these kids are at maybe the highest level they play, and plenty of them will go on and play in the ABL, but it's something that you never ever forget, becoming a national champion.
A big congratulations to the under 16 Victoria Blue team getting the gold medal here at Blue Sox Stadium at Blacktown International Sports Park. Don't go anywhere, 45 minutes away from first pitch in the under 18's gold medal game. It's going to be a great baseball afternoon. Look forward to having you join us here in 45 minutes. We'll be right back.
Ground ball back at the pitcher. Tola recovers, and Canberra are the champions of Australian baseball.
The month of February is fast approaching, and so too is the Australian Baseball League Championship Series. Who will claim the shield in...
I've got it.
I knew it. What model is it?